Lakai, all red.
Pacio's an exciting prospect. He's really, you know, come a long way in a very short period of time. He started fighting real young. He knows the importance of the opportunity that is at hand right now.
Well, it just piques everybody's interest when you see an undefeated record. 6-0 is a great way to start your career before you've even turned 21. That's what Pacio brings to the cage. Pacio, I should say, my apologies.
Pacio's throwing that nice lead kick like a lot of them do. See how he throws those legs around? It looks like a pair of nunchucks just flying around the cage.
Oh, took a belting kick to the inside of the thigh there. Catalan's clearly got some power with that left leg. And they're both swinging at it, aren't they?
Yeah, there's no setup, no hands, just all Whoa. Feet right now.
That was just a thudding kick to the inside of the knee.
You can do it, I can do it.
That's what it's going to be, a battle of the kicks. Well, suddenly we come upstairs with some fist fighting.
Yeah, Robin Catalan just has this intense stare.
He does, doesn't he?
Look at, he's just in very focused, like, evades the strikes, answers right back.
It's a kicking exhibition, loving this.
Oh, big single leg takedown, got that high crotch, picked him up, dropped him down, landed in side control.
Falls into the guillotine, though. I don't know if that's going to... No, he slipped out of it.
You can't finish a guillotine. I mean, you could. There's chokes you can do from there, but it's very difficult. You've got to be a highly skilled grappler to pull off that submission right there. But he, Robin Catalan kind of just shrimps out, ends up back in half guard, where he just has one of Pacio's legs. And he manages to, he's fighting for it. And Pacio kind of just shrugs it off and back into half guard. Now, a lot of fighters prefer to do their ground and pound from the half guard position. It just opens up so many more opportunities to leverage off and kind of push away and land strikes.
.245 left in this opening round. We'll be fighting for 3 5-minute rounds if it goes the distance. On championship judges, score fights in their entirety, not round by round.
Yuji Shimada slapping Katilang's foot off the cage there.
Good work with the forearms and elbows there from Pacio. Just being kept at a distance though, and here comes the leg work from his back there.
That was an interesting technique. He threw a leg kick from the bottom. Actually just swiveled his hips into that shot too. That's a nice little technique he got there.
Oh, came from way up there with that right hand. And Pacio is landing some heavy blows.
Good scramble, both fighters trying to establish dominance. Usually you think the guy on top is winning, but when you land some big strikes, you can really hurt your opponent by striking from the bottom and being active. Pacio's landing some good ground and pound. Really picking his shots very carefully. He creates space when he needs to and then drops those hands in.
Oh, he's doing good work from this position. It's pretty even when they were standing up. Pretty thrilling as well. Thought for a moment Pacio was going to let his man get to his feet, but no, in the end he changed his mind.
Uh-oh, there's a possible omoplata. Catalan's going for submissions. He's active off his back. He's threatening, you know, keeping Pacio kind of guessing exactly what he's going to be doing. Final 50 seconds here of round one. Hammer fist thrown by Pacio as he's trying to advance his position. You can see that he's trying to push the legs down. He's trying to move into a better position, but this ground and pound's pretty effective.
Well, if we get to the end of this round, we'll go to Rich Franklin and give you his idea of how he scored this. There's different criteria as to how we score a fight. Some are more important than others. Final 15 seconds of this opening round then.
Oh, snap, ends the round in the, from side control. So that's definitely a good position to kind of be in. And he gets to land a little bit of a knee there.
Yeah, you expect to see that coming in from side control from these two, don't you?
Grazing the head there of Katilan. Good opening round for Pacio, the fighter from Team Lakai. You can see here that he kind of gets that outside high crotch, picks him up into the air, puts him down onto the cage floor, and just ends up in side control. Here's that leg kick from the bottom position, which is a new technique for me. I love the innovation of that. Holds the legs and drops a big right hand down. Let's jump to Rich Franklin and see how he has it so far.
I'll tell you, I have Pacio ahead on the scorecards at this point in time. Katalan came out and he had some effective striking at the beginning of the round, and then Pacio basically just continued with the ground and pound on the bottom, was able to mount things up and do some damage on the bottom, so I have him ahead on the scorecards.
One round done, second one to come. Two Filipinos fighting in front of their home fans. He does have that kind of evil eye, doesn't he, Robin Catalan? Completely different looking character, Joshua Pacio. Just looks like a small boy in some ways. But you don't want to mess with this small boy. 20 years old, unbeaten in 6 professional mixed martial arts fights.
Reminds me a little bit of Sapo.
Really?
Sort of
yeah, no,
gauge,
yeah, I see that. I see
intensity.
That. Head down, big shoulders. Yeah. Yeah.
Joshua Pacio's threatening that push kick. You can see him trying to set up for it. Very light, spins to the side there. Good footwork, stays light on his feet. You can see the difference in just the stance alone, how Joshua's kind of nice and light on his feet, and Katalang's set and planted, just waiting to almost for the counter strike.
Yeah, he's very planted, isn't he? And you know that he's setting up that kick. Oh, these are tremendously good kicks. It's a great contest when they're standing up. First minute of the first round was enthralling.
Katalan's got a nice little lean back. He judges his distance really well and evades the strikes of Pacio just by slowly moving out of the way. That's it's a lot of Muay Thai fighters fight that way, as they just kind of slip out of the way there.
Katalan, and you referred to it a moment ago, is almost static, isn't he? He's so planted, looking to set up that left leg kick.
Yeah, he's hunting for it. He knows it. I'd like to see him set it up with maybe some punches. You know, you can see him just threatening it. And now Pacio knows it's coming, so he just pops out of the way.
Yeah, the fact that he's static is not a disadvantage, because he's so primed and poised to go Pacio won't be trying to take any advantage of that static position.
He's throwing that kick like it's coming out of a catapult, just ready to go and fire at any moment. You can see him switching stances, though. He's going back and forth, you know, changing things up a little bit. Oh, waiting. Oh, a little bit of a possible readjustment there of the groin there, protector. Doesn't seem to faze him, though.
Sweat dripping off these two already. After only 7 minutes of action. It's not the warmest arena we've ever been to. The air conditioning works very well here. Whoa, what a heavy takedown.
Really does a nice takedown. He gets in high and then just spins his opponents down as he puts him down onto the ground. Very good takedowns from Joshua Pacio. Pacio ends up in side control, though. That's a very good. He doesn't have to work, doesn't have to expend any energy, and just ends up nicely in side control.
Halfway point in the fight. Pacio on top after 5 minutes, according to Rich Franklin.
Beautiful time step over there. He waited for the right moment, waited for both Katalang's feet to be planted on the mat, and he just steps over really fast and ends up in mount. Now he's got 2 minutes to do some big work here. So Katalang's got to start moving.
Clearly, this is where Pacio develops the advantage. Katalan is covering up, not throwing anything back. Not all of those punches are getting through, but a few are, no question.
It's going to be stopped any minute now. You can't turtle up like that.
He covered up pretty well, you know, Robin Katalan.
only I'd say about 30% of those punches were landing, but the point is, nothing was coming back.
You have to move, Steve. You gotta let the guy punch you almost, put your hands on his hips, throw him off of you, and create that movement. Otherwise, you are done for. Here's some of those nice takedowns that Pacio was landing throughout the fight. That's pretty much just what really signified the end here. And you can just see Pacio just getting on top and letting it all go. Good debut and still undefeated in his mixed martial arts career.
How about that? 7-0 and 20 years old. Will we see more of Joshua Pacio? You bet we will. And these fans in the Mall of Asia Arena are excited for the prospect. Our strawweight champion is Dejan Rong Saw Amnoy Sirichok, and he will be defending his title at a show in Bangkok next month. That's what these two will be aiming for in time to come, and Joshua Pacio has just sharpened his focus on that prospect. And why not adjust your hair as you look up at the big screen?
He earned it.
Sure he did.
You're in the right. Good fight.
The official decision is with Anthony Suntai.
To award the prize to our winners, we have Al De Los Santos and Ms. Malu Tongol from PMC. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this bout at 3:19 of round number 2. For your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Joshua Pacio!
First fight of the night then, first fight in ONE Championship history in Macau. Beautiful part of the world, very exciting town, very exciting action tonight, and we've got off to an exciting start as Kritsada leaps in.
Growing.
See Kong Sirachai immediately gets in nice and tight with that clinch, but Joshua spins him around. Now he's got him up against the cage right now. Nice belly-to-belly suplex there to take him to the mount. Beautiful transition there off the cage.
Remember, Joshua has an unbeaten record to defend. And training up there in altitude in Baguio means he's gonna be good for cardio. 3 5-minute rounds, this one scheduled to go.
Big kick there, Pacio catches it and takes him to the ground. There's that headlock takedown he's attempting right there by Kong Sirachai. Again, Pacio uses the control to drive him down, but almost like a sacrifice throw, and Kong Sirachai ends up on top.
Very busy, big sense of urgency from these two early on. More knees to the head from Kong Sirachai. As he holds Joshua's head down, that head becomes a bit of an open target in that position. Josh shook himself free.
Pop himself out, and Pacio looks very explosive in a lot of his escapes. Sirachai is so dangerous in that clinch. He's got those suplexes and those takedowns that almost come out of nowhere.
Despite being a wrestler, Kong Sirachai likes that knee to the body that's very reminiscent of a Muay Thai fighter.
Yeah, he doesn't like getting into the clinch much. He doesn't go into the Muay Thai clinch. He's primarily got that over-under grip, and he loves the belly-to-belly suplex, or possibly even that headlock takedown he likes.
See how strong Joshua's legs are as he pressures his opponent up against the cage wall. Can be a tiring business, that.
Action!
Pacio shoots him for the legs. Now he's got a single leg. Good defense by Kong Sirachai. Nice wide base, spins him around. Ooh. That elbow just thudded off the top of Pacio's head. Those elbows are so dangerous.
Halfway mark in the opening round. Swung those punches in, Joshua, without really looking where they were going. Wanted to keep his head down and his face out of trouble.
Drops his head and hopes for the best as he swings for the fences there. See, I gotta wonder why, you know, Pacio is attempting to clinch and maintain these things. Now he's got double unders now, where he's got both hands underneath Kong Sirachai. But you can see how Kong Siracha has kind of laced his arms over Pacio so that he can probably, that's a, you know, a suplex possible position right there. He spins him off the cage. And there that is, nice little trip to end up in side control.
So remember, Kong Siracha is a wrestler. That's his place.
Nice escape again from Pacio. He's got the single leg. Let's see if he can take down the wrestler now.
Huge noise that the fans are making here at the finish on the count.
And Pacio scores a takedown in the half guard. Let's see what Kong Siracha is like off his back. He's able to get almost back into full guard, where he's got both legs wrapped around Pacio almost. He might try to step over the leg there and get into half guard. Yep, gets over one leg. Now he's gonna try to slide that right leg of his through that knee and attempt to pass into side control. So you can see him pushing down the knee. Up, he ends up in the mount instead. It's a bad spot for Kong Siracha to be in.
So what can he do with 50 seconds left in the opening round? Plenty of time to do some damage.
He's a little bit high up on the back. He's trying to flatten him out. You can see Pacio. Now he's gonna rain down some punches. Uh-oh, one hand's under the neck. There's a rear naked choke.
Yuji Shibata's looking closely at this, watching for the tap. Is that arm underneath the chin and around the throat? 30 seconds left to find out.
Kong Siracha's got to try to peel that arm off.
It's over. Yuji stopped it. He must have seen a tap that I couldn't see from the screen here in front of me, and nor from the other side of the cage where I am.
Yeah, Steve, I think he went out. That choke was deep, and Kong Siracha, there was no quitting him at all. Pacio put him to sleep.
I think that could well have been the situation. Joshua Pacio improves his unbeaten record to 8-0. Mark Sangio, head of Team Lakai, very proud of his young man there. Remember, he's only 20 years old. Still unbeaten. 8 big wins in his career. Now, let's see what we can see from some of these replays. This was about... Oh, that right hand from him took that punch well. But it was once they got down and Kong Siracha managed to turn around. There he is, giving him his back. And then it was the choke underneath the chin that did the damage.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimano calls a hold to this battle at 4:37 of round number one. Rear winner by submission via rear naked choke, Joshua Pacio!
Nobita moving forward, very aggressive, nice and relaxed is Pacio.
This could be a very nervous fight for...
This fight is brought to you by FNI, assuring peace of mind, the essence of life.
This could be a very nervous fight for Joshua Pacio as, you know, he's up against someone that's undefeated with more experience than him. But, you know, he wants to get this fight, he wants to get this belt, he's going to take it to Yoshitaka.
Good movement displayed by both fighters. Pacio is moving forward now, nice and relaxed.
Throwing those leg kicks, throwing that body shot there. You know, he's going to be throwing out a lot of strikes during this fight, and Yoshitaka is going to have to move around and try and catch one of those legs, but they are so fast.
Yeah, they are coming with lightning fast speed as Pacio attempts a body shot there.
Another kick misses. Yoshitaka Naito is diving in for a takedown.
Good sprawl by Pacio. Nobita's been focusing a lot on his hands, and also he's been working a lot on his lateral movement, and it's on display right now. He's moving very well as he dives in for a single leg, and Pacio's showing great takedown defense, Peter.
Yoshitaka, this could be like first round nerves, but I don't think so, really. Maybe he's just a little bit tired, I'm not sure. That was a fantastic kick by Joshua Pacio there, and it really caused some damage, I'm sure. Now,
Nice jabs thrown by Naito. I like that. I'd like to see him put these combinations together instead of just diving for these takedowns. Yeah. Put some punches together and then follow it up with a single leg.
Naito did good with those few strikes before he attempted that takedown. And again, the takedown, he's like, he's changing level and diving in, but he's doing it at such a distance that it's becoming like too easy to read. And there you go, Wushu spinning back kick there from Joshua Pacio. And you know, this is what's exciting about this fight. Two different styles and two undefeated fighters going at it in the cage, looking to get that belt and take it home.
He might as well throw a Facebook message at him and before he lets him know that it's coming, because he's diving right in and announcing that the takedown is coming. He's got to put something together to disguise that takedown a little better, Peter.
Or at least drive him to the cage. If he drives into the cage, Joshua has nowhere to go, and you can shoot in like that and it's not going to be a problem at all, unless Joshua throws one of his knees up. And, you know, Joshua is happily throwing strikes. He's in the center of the cage, and Yoshitaka is he's being a bit nervous with his striking. He's not going in all the... He's not going all out, I don't think. But, you know, this is a five-round fight, so maybe these guys are keeping a little bit back for the later rounds.
Yeah, Naito said he believes this fight is going to go into the championship rounds, because he knows just how explosive Pacio is, but he's never been in a five-round fight. This is the first time Pacio's been fighting in a five-round title fight.
And you're right, Pacio is extremely explosive. He just, you know, scrubbed off one of those takedowns, and he had his back against the cage after a reshoot from Yoshitaka, and he pushed the fight away, and they're both standing up back in the center of the cage again. Well, you know, there's an age difference, and 32 versus 20. When you hit your 30s, everything starts to go downhill. Big, strong left hand from Joshua there. Pacio maybe coming away on the striking here a little bit, but we saw some good jabs from Yoshitaka, and there you go, a jab from each of them. Head kick from Joshua. Let's see if they can put more combinations together instead of single strikes. Spinning back kick. Joshua really knows when he's got that distance down. That's, you know, that's the Wushu thing. He is certain he can get that kick in. He just spins, turns around, and doesn't worry about another takedown from such a great distance there from Naito. And, you know, he's telegraphing that, and Joshua just stuffs it. Big overhand from Joshua there, just glances off the shoulder.
Pacio is doing a great job in showcasing some tremendous takedown defense, and that is probably the last place in the world he wants to be, as he's consistently pushing forward. He's moving well. This is a young fighter who is very actually living up to the moment.
He is hungry. He is truly, truly hungry. And I think that's the difference between the 20-year-old and our 32-year-old.
You know, Naito gonna change things up, but look at this sprawl right here. Just easily sees it coming, sprawls his hips back. The pressure applied and answers right back with some significant strikes.
Big leg kick there as well. Yeah, again, stuffing those takedowns, no problem. Nice left hook after that stuff. Another attempt stuffed here. We can see that Yoshitaka Naito is having a real trouble.
We know Naito's game plan, single leg takedown, drag this fight to the ground.
It doesn't appear to be working too well. There are too many takedown stuffs going on here, too much sprawling happening from Joshua Pacio. And again, same thing, knees happening there. I just saw Naito's face. He does appear to have taken some damage from some of the strikes. Yes, you can see clearly there's a little bit of damage on Naito's right hand side. Joshua Pacio quite happily throwing in jabs. Yeah, if he just gets one takedown though, might that change the whole fight?
It could, but you got to keep in mind these guys are starting to get slippery, and as explosive as Pacio is, he might be able to pop right back up. There's that single leg. Now he's got that. Is this the only takedown he needs to finish the fight? Look at the hip control. The way that he controls the hips and keeps his opponents from getting away is very impressive. We saw that in the title win by Naito.
Look, he's got him down. He's pressuring him. You know, he's got one leg trapped, but otherwise he's going to try and pass that leg right now. Naito is doing a good job of working from that takedown in order to throw some ground control into the cage right now. He's going to try and pass the guard and then throw in some ground and pound. But Joshua Pacio is doing a good job of throwing elbows from that position where he's on his back. And, you know, he's getting some strikes in and causing some damage. He's pushing away on the shoulders. Naito's still trapped with that one leg there. You know, that's not going to be beneficial for him. He wants to try and jump over that. And Joshua Pacio continues to strike from that position, and it looks to be quite effective. Now in the guard, it's changed position again. Joshua Pacio doing a good job. A guillotine attempt, not very deep at all. So, you know, the crowd went a bit wild for that. But, you know, Naito working the position as best he can. He's got the hand on the hip. He's trying to control the hips of Joshua. But now he's going for ground and pound. He might like to sit up a little bit more so he can get more power into his ground and pound. But maybe he's a bit afraid of what Joshua Pacio can do from that position.
The way that he's controlling the hips and is able to keep Pacio in this position is really impressive. But Pacio's doing all the right things. He's trying to push away. He's trying to create space. But Naito just gets so tight and so close.
He even tried a Kimura sweep at one point there, did Pacio. However, his back is firmly on the mat, and also Naito is pressing all of his weight down on him, so you won't be able to do it now. Those elbows, however, are very sharp and nasty, and that might do some significant damage and make Naito want to just stand up and get out of this position. Joshua Pacio has him stuck in his guard right now and is striking from guard, something I like to do actually, but kicks him away to get back up into a stand-up game.
See, Naito was on top there, but Joshua was the one that was doing all the damage.
Indeed, and you know, when Joshua decided to get back up, he got back up. So, you know, Naito is going to have to work hard again to get another takedown, you know, that's going to be able to get the fight to the ground and keep it there. 17, it could be. How many win streaks are Team Lakai on right now, Mitch?
They just got their 16th win in a row from Kevin Bellegong. Can you imagine if the 20-year-old undefeated fighter becomes Team Lakai's first world champion?
I couldn't believe that. I would not be happy. He would get, you know, shark tanked on Monday for getting that belt, and none of the more senior veteran fighters having it instead.
They'll have a parade in Baguio if he does become the first world champion.
For sure they will, for sure they will. Again, Naito trying to push the fight up against the cage, but Pacio coming back with a lovely strike there that really rocked him. Sprawling, slamming him down on the ground. Again, Naito's attempts at takedowns are just getting squashed.
I'm sorry, Peter. Onario Bonario was the first Team Lakai world champion, but Joshua Pacio could be the second if the fight continues to go in this way.
Indeed, it could be the case. He's got that single leg again, and it's the single legs that really do make a difference from a close range. Okay, now we're up against the cage. Joshua Pacio throwing in those elbows. He's trying to get that, the neck there, possibly, but it's the last 10 seconds of the round, so it's going to be difficult to do anything from these positions that both of the fighters are in.
Let's take a look at some of the past action in that round.
See that single leg, head on the inside, turning around, you know, continuing to turn clockwise in order to get the fight to the ground until Pacio's arm gave way, staying in position, pressuring the hips down from Naito there in Pacio's guard. Pacio does some really nice striking there. He does some punches. He did some really hard elbows.
Fight!
Let's see if the game plan changes for either one of these fighters, but they're both doing exactly what we thought they would do.
I mean, this is really exciting. We're in the third round of the Strawweight World Championship fights right here. And, you know, everything is on the line. Naito has the belt, wants to take it home, but Pacio is 20 years old. He's hungry. He wants to be the second belt holder in Team Lakai and wants to keep that 17 Team Lakai win streak going.
if it does go to 17. It's not 17 yet, Peter. Right now it's at 16. Let's not jump to conclusions, because we've got a world-class fighter in there, Naito, defending his world championship.
He's doing everything he can to do that. He's doing so many takedown attempts. You know, they may not be translating into, like, damage or like big points of ground control. However, he is really trying to get this fight to the ground and finish it with his style. Yeah, a lot of the takedowns are being blocked right now by Joshua Pacio. And I think that's generally because he shoots in from too far away and makes it too obvious. They're telegraphed. But he does like this close range, single leg. They're right in front of us now, cage side. You see, he just spins around. Very good wrestling there.
Beautiful takedown. Now he's got the rear
naked choke. Oh, my goodness. Rear naked choke.
He's under the chin.
That is deep. That is so deep.
No!
Oh, my goodness. He's got that hook in on one side, and he got it really, really deep. He put it on top of the shoulder, and then he dug the arm in. He doesn't even have two hooks, and now he's got the body lock, the body triangle. That was deep, and Joshua Pacquiao's face, it was a look of sadness there, as he knew he'd lost every hope of winning that.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to the fight after 1 minute and 33 seconds in the third round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke submission, and still one strawweight world champion, Yoshitaka Naito!
A shot at the title with a convincing performance from one of these two tonight. One championship. All on the line here tonight. Another epic episode of Thailand versus the Philippines.
That's right, Chris. Both these fighters feel they deserve another shot at the belt. And one minor mistake was all it took to cost them the strap. And now is their shot to get it back into the title hunt.
Pacio going with the high point kick. Amnoy Sirichok stalking forward. Pacio moving backwards. Sirichok with a switch kick blocked by Pacio.
Typically, we see Crew Wrong, which is Amnoy Sirichok's nickname. We see him start a little bit slower, but he's actually really trying to put the pressure on Pacquiao, and he's starting a lot faster than he usually does.
And as we see him close down the distance, it would seem to be to the avoidance of the movement skills and speed of Pacquiao. Big kick again there from Amnoy Sirichok. Pacquiao presses the clinch.
When you fought Muay Thai over 350 times at the absolute highest level, you have a skill set on your feet that is incomparable to anybody out there. You gotta wonder when Pacquiao is gonna try to take this to the ground, because you can see him try an outside trip there, but Dej has got just such a strong base, and he just really stops. He's really so strong in the clinch, but he's gotta try to swim underneath Pacquiao. Ah. Pacio was able to get the double underhooks, use that to get this fight to the ground.
Pacio using those deep underhooks, as Mitch explained there, to destabilize Amnoy Sirichok. And here with plenty of time on the clock, Mitch, Pacio probably where he wanted this one from the beginning.
Yeah, that's exactly where he wants to be. He wants to be on top, have Amnoy Sirichok on the bottom, and just tire him out. Utilize those body shots like he's doing right now to slowly start to watch Amnoy Sirichok fade. But it's just not going to happen. And it's only a three-round fight. We didn't see Amnoy Sirichok start to fade until like that fourth and fifth round when he fought Naito, because he's got the juice to go all three rounds pretty heavily.
And Amnoy Sirichok doing the right thing here to try to pull Pacio down, break his posture, and hand fight a bit, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing that. He's definitely trying to stop the ground and pound, but he's keeping his guard closed, which just traps Pacio in that ground and pound position. So he's just kind of holding him there to drop these bombs. He's got to let go of the feet and start to scramble and maybe get back up to his feet.
Referee watching very carefully here, and somebody right now, Mitch, needs to work to improve their position. But it's Amnoy Sirichok going here to grab the neck.
He's got a guillotine, and the crowd is definitely responding to this packed arena here at Impact Stadium. But I think he's a bit too high. He's only got one hand on it, so he's really just holding the head of Pacquiao. Pacquiao's gonna pop his head out like he just did, and really just see how he's just softening up the body. But I like how Amnoy Sirichok's throwing elbows from the bottom.
And the name of the game here would be to perhaps force a stand-up.
Ooh, that's what he needed to do. He opened his guard, shrimped out to the side, and started moving away, but Pacio immediately jumped over that and ended up in a half guard. But we see Pacio, he's really not trying to pass the guard of Omnoy Sirichoke. He's just able to sit there, and he's content just to beat him up, which is that ground and pound that we spoke about at the beginning of the fight.
Right now, Pacio capitalizing on a momentary lapse of concentration from Omnoy Sirichoke, sitting here in half. Olivia Coates calling for both fighters to work here. But I feel like the onus is on Pacio right now.
Yeah, definitely. He's definitely scoring a lot of the ground and pound, and he's controlling the top position. Most people believe if you're on top, you're winning the fight, unless you're doing a lot of damage or you're really throwing up a lot of submissions, which Omnoy Sirichoke is not doing right now. He's just kind of holding on to that half guard, and he's also holding on to the body, which is draining. It's going to take a lot of energy to hold on to somebody as strong as Pacio is and try not to let him go.
And he's certainly trying to protect himself and use that lockdown. As you'll see, he's got the ankle underneath his calf and, of course, the other ankle grapevined in, Mitch. He's doing the right thing, but the big question is it enough?
Yeah, he's got the black belt, Progenio Issa, in his corner right now, shouting out instructions through the translator in the corner there. So Omnoy Sirichoke has the best vantage point possible, but Pacio is just too much on top. The ground and pound coming from Pacio. Looks like he might have a neck here and a guillotine.
Pacio looking to finish here, holding on to the neck. Just a few seconds left in the round. And the fans cheering for Omnoy Sirichoke, who has certainly had to weather an early storm as Pacio ends the round on top. Would you just listen to the fans in here, Mitch?
Yeah, we saw the ground and pound from Pacio. We saw the Muay Thai from Omnoy Sirichoke, and every fight's gonna start onto his feet. Look at this beautiful head movement there to counter with a kick of his own. But then this is where the story of the fight really started to happen. The top control of Pacio, where he was just able to control, soften him up. It'll be interesting to hear Rich Franklin's opinion on what he thought of that first round.
Well, I'll tell you, when the round first started, I had Dej actually come out and score a little bit on the stand-up with the striking superiority, but that was overshadowed by the ground control that Pacio had there. And although this is showing the ground control, I have Pacio scoring in the damage category as well. A lot of superficial damage because you see the cut that they're working on Dej's face there, but you can see when Dej was walking away at the end of the round, you can see the hematomas on the right side of his head too. So that damage actually starting to add up. So Pacio's beginning to score in the higher categories. At this point in time, I have him ahead on the scorecards.
Well, it's been a workmanship performance thus far from Pacio. And when we saw plenty of striking from the outset, Mitch, it became really a grappling affair for most of that round.
And that it did, but we didn't really see a lot of grappling. We saw just the control of Pacio on top. Once he was able to get on top, he didn't choose to pass. He wasn't trying to advance his position. He was content just to sit there on top and beat Omnoy Sirichoke.
Well, the second of a scheduled 3, 5 minutes on the clock here, and it starts on the feet, just like in the previous round. Let's see what happens between two men who we know can strike.
Pacio's threatening that side kick again. Look how fast that kick comes out. No setup whatsoever, he just throws it out there.
Omnoy Sirichoke with the punishing counter. And Pacio certainly taking a very quick route on those kicks. Not as much power, Mitch, but certainly quick kicks.
Big leg kick by Omnoy Sirichoke. This is where he needs to keep the fight. He needs to keep his distance, but he's consistently moving forward. If Pacio, yep, caught a kick, picks him up, sends him down with a huge takedown to end up in side control, which is not a good spot for Omnoy Sirichoke.
A single kick from Omnoy Sirichoke and the penalty, an opportunity for Pacio to take him down and straight into side control. Mitch, that's efficient.
Yeah, I would have thought the corner would have been like, all right, ease up on the leg kicks, let's throw some hands, let's keep this fight on the feet, start moving around. But Pacio caught that leg kick, and now we're back in the same position that we ended the first round in, and there's a lot of time for Pacio to start working.
Pacio working the wrestling department here again in half and utilizing the odd ground and pound to try to open up position and possibly a pass.
Yeah, this is a good position for Pacio. He's really able to do a lot of damage. We've got 3.5 minutes left, and this is where Pacio is going to be able to do most of his handiwork. He's just on top, dropping that ground and pound, and that's really been the story of the fight so far in what we're approaching is the first half of the fight.
He's going to work on that far side arm. Tough to see from our angle here on the monitor. There we go, much better. Possible straight arm bar here.
Yeah, he's got the straight arm bar, but he might transition into a Kimura where Amnoy Sirichoke seems to be keeping the arm straight. It's going to be very hard to submit at that position. Amnoy Sirichoke just shook it off. He's got to create more scrambles. He's like trying to maybe conserve his energy, but Pacio is really strong on top, so I could be wrong in saying that he's not trying to create scrambles, but Pacio is just controlling and grounding and pounding.
One thing interesting of note here is that Pacio, there we go, that was what I was looking for, was an attempt to try to actively pass and not just use the ground and pound to try to open up a pass. Pressing on the knee, Pacio now trying to force his way into mount, but great defense there from Amnoy Sirichoke.
Yeah, he's defending, he's keeping it in half guard, but he's worrying more about the pass, so he's enabling Pacio to drop even more shots into him. And he's controlling, he has got a cradle position. This is Amnoy Sirichoke's shot to get back up to his feet.
Oh, Amnoy Sirichoke trying to explode. Pacio thinking about the back take here and goes with the body lock.
Amnoy Sirichoke gave up his back in the attempt to get back up to his feet. He might get suplexed here, but Pacio transitions to a single leg. Beautiful takedown by Pacio.
Great defense there from Amnoy Sirichoke again, but Pacio one step ahead. Gets him down again to the canvas here. Let's see what he can do with it.
I think it's gonna be more of the same, Chris. I think he's just comfortable to sit in the half guard and start dropping bombs because I don't think he might try to pass. It looks like he's trying to work the knee up towards the hips of Amnoy Sirichoke to maybe pop that knee out through the legs. But it's just, this is where he does his best work. He likes to control the opponents and really just beat him up from the top.
And certainly when you consider the striking skills of Amnoy Sirichoke, despite Pacio being proficient in that department, this is probably the path of least resistance.
Yeah, there's very few people in the world that can stand up with him. And actually, there might be a few of them here in the stadium tonight, but because we are in Thailand. But primarily, this is where Pacio wants to keep this fight. He wants to keep it on the ground, keep Amnoy Sirichoke back flat against the mat here. And just now he's attempting the Kimura again. It looks like he's trying to attack the far side arm, but Amnoy Sirichoke's doing the right thing by keeping his elbows nice and tight, but the crowd is really getting into this little bit of a ground and pound exchange by these two.
And even as Amnoy Sirichoke throws short punches and elbows off his back, the crowd cheering every time they land. But Pacio staying busy just enough to keep this one down on the ground.
And that's exactly his game plan. You can hear Mark Sangrio yelling at him what he wants him to do. And that's gotta be just keep him down, beat him up on the mat, and eventually, when this round ends in about 20 seconds, 10 seconds, they're gonna get another shot on the feet. And you gotta wonder, is Dej's corner gonna be like, all right, no more leg kicks, let's use just the hands and see if we can change the possible destiny of this contest here tonight.
The crowd at fever pitch here in the Impact Arena as we see the second round come to a close. A flurry from both men. It started on the feet. Talk us through the action, Mitch.
Yeah, here's the leg kick. He threw the leg. Boom. Pacio was able to transition right into a big takedown. And here's that attempted Kimura a straight arm bar that Dej Demerong was able to run off. But then this was the story of the fight. Pacio able to get on top, control where the fight's happening, and just beat up Dej from the top. Rich, what do you got?
I'll tell you, Pacio just increased his lead on the ground control there. And I might go so far as to say that Dej may actually need to knock him out in order to win this fight. Pacio's had too much time on the ground as far as control, and he's also scoring in the damage category, which is a higher category. You saw the armbar there on the replay. I did not score him a near sub. It just wasn't close enough to actually make any score there, but I have some notation on my score sheet. But at this point in time, he's increased his lead so much that, like I said, in order for Dej to win this, he may actually need to get a finish here.
And we will put 5 minutes on the clock, the final round of this contest. And possibly, as you heard it from Rich Franklin, as well as Mitch Chilson alongside me here tonight at the Impact Arena, that amount of time left for Amnoy Sirichok to finish this contest if he wants a win.
He's got, see, he immediately keeps going, he goes right after the punches, and that needs to be where he needs to go. He needs to throw the hands, stay away from the takedown, be careful with his kicks, because Pacio is snatching those kicks up very quickly, and he's able to transition into some big takedowns.
And you're seeing, again, a lot of pressure here from Amnoy Sirichok. Constant forward movement. On the back foot is Pacio. Left hand followed by Amnoy Sirichok, and then Pacio thinking about the takedown, shrugged off. That's better from Amnoy Sirichok.
Yeah, that's what he wants. He wants to be able to stop the takedown, but I like how he's not throwing any kicks. He's going just after the hands. Nice uppercut there from Pacio, though.
Overextension from Amnoy Sirichok. Uppercut counter there from Pacio. Man, these are some exchanges, Mitch.
He stopped the takedown, and now we got ourselves a boxing match. So let's see what kind of gas that Pacio has as he shoots in for the takedown. Dej is able to stop it. Very good.
Third time again, shut down by Amnoy Sirichok. Pacio now for the first time, possibly on the back foot more often than not. Surging in confidence is Amnoy Sirichok. Wow, what an incredible opportunity here for Pacio. Can you get him down?
Oh, that was a good shot. He faked the takedown, went right back after it again. Just that constant chain wrestling, going for takedown after takedown. Amnoy Sirichok sprawling heavy, able to stop his third takedown of this round. He's got to turn it on. He's got 3 minutes for the knockout, as Rich Franklin says, might be his only way to win this fight.
Well, the reshot there from Pacio was impressive indeed, but Dej in stalking mode, man, as he goes off the left hand, the crowd really hanging on the edge of their seat here at the Impact Arena. As the title connects again with the right hand, Pacio in desperation mode, thinking about the double leg, Mitch.
He's got him up against the cage. This might be a chance for him to gather his wits, because it looked like Dej Demeron connected with some big shots there.
Pacio trying to get those hands together. Amnoy Sirichok able to keep his hips away and continues to pour on the pressure. The clock is running over the midway point of this round.
Pacio looks to be fading a little bit. He looks a little bit tired. His mouth is open as Dej starts to pour it on with a body shot. Goes to the body, goes to the head. Oh, with a big right hand.
Body head from Amnoy Sirichok as he continues to waltz forward and pour on the multiple punch combinations. Pacio looks tired, Mitch.
They're giving the crowd exactly what they want. The Philippine versus Thailand striking battle.
And Amnoy Sirichok continues to plot onwards. Out comes the mouthpiece from Pacio. Pacio looks rocked.
But look at the chin of Pacio. He's hanging in there with a Lupini, a three-time Lupini world champion. Shoots it for the takedown. Dej shuts it off, gets his back.
Amnoy Sirichok looking for the back take. The right hand punches coming in, and he's got the seatbelt, Mitch.
He's got the back. Pacio trying to stand up as Dej starts to hammer. It's important to know we are judging the fight on its entirety, not round by round. Big head kick.
Oh, man, what a connection again from the Thai fighter. So much aggression and certainly plenty of accuracy from Amnoy Sirichok.
I like the uppercut that Pacio's throwing because it's landing, but Dej is stalking after the Filipino, throwing heavy hands. They trade push kicks and continue to battle. Finally, Olivier Cost gives Pacio his mouthpiece back.
What a fight. What a fight tonight. And the crowd absolutely in so much support for Amnoy Sirichok. Pacio struggling to put things together. Can he turn it around, Mitch?
This is very close. He's doing a lot of good, but Pacio is really hanging in there. He looks a little bit tired, but he's still answering right back, and he's also landing strikes. Dej just is moving forward, and he's got the crowd on his side, but Pacio is right in there still.
And it's a sprint to the finish line as Amnoy Sirichok rips to the legs with the kicks. Pacio looking for something here. Amnoy Sirichok, a swing and a miss. 10-second clapper's gone.
Pacio is doing good. He's standing there. He got caught with a leg kick. I would like to see him catch it, going for the takedown. That could have been the punctuation mark he needed.
but a body kick to end the round. What a fight, Chris.
What a performance from Amnoy Sirichok in the third round. But Pacio was oh so impressive to take the TIE fighter out of his game. Mitch, that was full fat action for 5 minutes.
This was a very impressive part of the story for me here, how he's able to push the head down, stop three takedown attempts very effectively to keep this fight on the feet. He stopped with the kicks, went after the hands, and there's a big right hand from Pacio. Rich Franklin, what do you got for him?
I'll tell you what, look, both of these guys were aggressive. I gave Dez the aggression category. Obviously, Pacio won the takedown category. Dez was still able to defend some takedowns. Ground control Pacio the whole fight, but there was no ground in the third round there. In the third round, Dez actually ran away with the striking superiority. I think he actually mounted more damage, but the time of control on the ground was in Pacio's favor, and I would give him the decision here.
Wow, Amnoy Sirichok came back with everything he had, showed a lot of fight IQ in the third there, but a lot of domination on display from Pacio, who will take that one step closer to title contention here tonight for the packed out crowd at the Impact Arena at One Championship Warrior Kingdom. So much there. The first time we go the distance tonight. And we will hear from Dominic Lau to make the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout for the blue corner. Judge number two scores this bout for the red corner. And judge number three scores this bout for your winner, by way of split decision, from the blue corner, Joshua Pacio.
Challenge of One Championship will be too much for the Japanese superstar. Pacio, speed, power, youth on his side. Whipping high roundhouse kicks early, going for the headache maker.
Nice little spinning back kick there as Suzuki closes the distance and gets nice and tight up to the cage.
Pacio has laid waste to five opponents in the first round with his Muay Thai, Wushu, and extensive ground capabilities. If it goes to ground, look out for the guillotine choke to the rear naked choke, and we're on the ground now.
Pacio was trying to keep his back nice and flat up against the cage, so Suzuki was not able to secure the back position and get that second hook around the body of Pacio.
Suzuki is a rear naked choke specialist. He's tapped out six opponents.
Oh, look how he did that, Michael. He kicked off the cage to get Pacio away from the cage so he couldn't keep his back there. Now he's got the back and he's looking for that second hook.
It's dangerous for Pacio once he gives the back to Suzuki.
You can see Pacio, he's trying to defend the leg there, but Suzuki is just relentless trying to get that hook in, and now he does it.
Suzuki will want to get another rear naked choke. He can put you to sleep quicker than dipping your head in a bucket of chloroform. And can he put Pacio asleep in the first round? The Filipino defending, he's got the crowd behind him. We are seeing if Hayato Suzuki is the real deal outside of Japan.
Look at him. Again, Pacio's trying to fight off that hook, but he gets it back in, and the arm is under the neck. Joshua Pacio's got to defend that left arm and keep that arm away from his neck. A little bit of hand fighting there going on. You can see Suzuki trying to lace that left hand around the neck of Pacio.
Elbows there from Hayato Suzuki, still has the back of Pacio. Pacio's got some great wins over varied styles of fighters, including a TKO of Filipino Wushu champion Robin Catalan, and a submission of Thai wrestling champion Kitsada Krong Sirichai last August. Suzuki resets this choke attempt. Pacio defending. Halfway through the opening round, it's been a thriller so far.
Pacio's only loss did come to another Japanese fighter, the champion Naito. And guess how he lost, Michael? By a rear naked choke.
Halftime, halftime.
Will history repeat itself, or has he learned from that defeat and learned how to defend all of the rear naked choke attempts?
We're finding out a lot about Suzuki. That choke is getting closer. The chin tucked here on Pacio. Continues to defend the young Filipino.
Now he's got that hand free. The right arm was what was keeping him from getting it deep. Can he lock it up? Is he gonna go palm to palm, or is he gonna grab the bicep?
Oh, this is Suzuki's specialty. Is he gonna send Pacio to sleep? Suzuki, oh, it's good night, Irene!
Impressive grappling display by Hayato Suzuki. Everything he did, from the way that he kicked off the cage to secure the back position of Joshua Pacio to the way that he snuck that rear naked choke in. Look at this. It's up. He's defending. Up. Oh, that's right there. Slid right under the chin, and that's all she wrote.
Hayato Suzuki goes 17-0.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 3 minutes and 17 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Hayato Suzuki!
The elder statesman, Roy Deligues, in the white and blue. A 21-year-old Pacio in the red. Southpaw stance as always on DeLeague as he fakes a jab. Beautiful cracking roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Pacio. Said he wants to stay at kickboxing range, not sit in the pocket, not be in boxing range with DeLeague. Quite smart.
Yeah, that kicking range really makes these Team Mackay athletes so dangerous. Look at his footwork, the way he floats around the outside of the cage. Oh, beautifully again catches him with that right kick. That's three now he's caught him with.
In typical boxer fashion, however, Roy Deligues looks to control center cage and press Pacio to the outside. Pacio suits in, nice sprawl there from Deligues. Defensive takedown. Defender gets a trip reversal here. Deligues looks for top position dragon.
Deligues does a beautiful job controlling that underhook of Pacio and using that wizard to get him over on top. Now, Pacio's got double underhooks. This is where Team Lakai really excels in the takedowns.
Take out from Pacio, top position. Mounts in, great finds the legs here. Dominance from Joshua Pacio.
So strong in that clinch position. And look at that, he was just able to fall on top and land in full mount.
Not where the boxer Deligues wants to be, though he said he's not afraid to go to the ground with Pacio. Believes that he's got a few submission tricks up his proverbial sleeve. Still mounted here. Those legs being great find by Joshua Pacio.
Don't hit it back
overhand. Okay. Nice little pop in right hand to the orbital there that switches to the left as Pacio.
Good control, trying to keep the pressure down. You can see Deligues trying to control the posture of Pacio. Pacio's in a good spot, but big bridge by Deligues to reverse the position to end up on top.
Now it's Roy Deligues inside the guard of Pacio. 3 minutes remaining, first round, set for 3 by 5.
It was surprising, Michael, to hear Deligues talk about. He knew that Pacio was going to take him down, so he was working specifically on submissions to catch Pacio.
Pacio said he'd submit him with an armbar or a rear naked choke. He did ask Deligues, if you were going to submit Pacio, what do you think you'd catch him with? And he said rear naked. Inside closed guard here, trying to pop the head out. Deligues free of any danger right now.
Time.
Looks like we got a referee timeout. Looks like there possibly could have been a headbutt. Maybe an eye poke when he was trying to get his hands, or trying to get free from the guillotine. We're going to show that again in a replay, but I think he had his hands on his face and he was trying to pry his head out of the guillotine.
Yellow card being issued there from referee Kim Chang. Yuji Shimada also having words there with Deligues. So Deligues has been punished here for this pitch.
Yeah, right there. As he was trying to get his hands out, he had his fingers in the eye of Joshua Pacio. That's a dangerous move right there, and he was issued a yellow card for that specific move.
So Deliga is being issued a yellow card. Further warnings from both referee Kim Ching and Yuji Shimada. And they're just checking that Joshua Pacio, the 21-year-old, is okay to go on, checking his vision in that right eye. Certainly an aggressive start to what is proving to be an intriguing battle in the opening round between these two strawweights. Injury time being allotted here for Pacio. Now he does have as much as 5 minutes to make a full recovery. And don't forget our double main event later tonight. Sellout crowd expected here at Mall of Asia Arena. For the first time ever, champion versus champion. Edward Filiang takes on Martin Nguyen for the lightweight championship of the world. And in our co-main event, Adriano Moraes, the Brazilian phenom, looks to defend the flyweight world title against Danny Kingan. Also on a stacked card from top to tail, Kevin Bellingham takes on Kevin Chung. Alex Silva and Hayato Suzuki is a battle of the grapplers, the submission specialist. 2 men who want to get into the winner's circle, Anupong Bunrad and Aussie Grease Lightning, Reese McLaren. Deliga is ready to go. Looks like Pacio is almost ready to go. Final words here from referee Kim Ching. Kim's only been brought onto the ONE Championship team recently, but already doing an outstanding job. And he will recommence their match from the position they were in when he
fell. Back into the guard now. Deliga is on top. They're going to actually restart him back in the guillotine position with his head trapped under his arm.
And Deliga has the head free. Is Pacio going to try and apply another choke? Probably not the best for this position. Deliga is looking to push him up against the cage bats. Where does Pacio go from here, Mitch?
He's going to try to scoot his hips back against the cage and use it to wall off back up. Now he's trying to scoot his hips out to the side, possibly looking to take the back of Deliga, but Deliga is following the hips.
Deliga is trying to posture up and maybe work the hammer fist strike off the right hand. Elbows to the clavicle there from Pacio. 1 minute 40 remains, first round set for 3. What's Deliga looking to do here, Mitch?
It looks like Pacio is actually attempting to go after the Kimura there on the right side of Deliga, possibly looking to sweep him over. Yeah, there's the Kimura fully locked in.
And uses it.
Uses it, the Kimura. Not as so much as a submission attempt, but really just to sweep Deliga and end up in the top position. Now in mount.
Knee bar or rear naked choke was a prediction from Pacio. Deliga now top position. Back inside the guard of Pacio. We are seeing truly a seesawing contest on the ground here on the first dragon.
That's the third time that Deliga has been able to hit bridge out of the mount position. So those are some tremendously strong hips, Michael, for him to keep doing that to Pacio.
Deliga said he'd been working on his ground game, said he felt quite comfortable to go to ground with Pacio. 4-week training camp for Roy Deliga. A massive 2-month camp for Joshua Pacio.
Again, hunting for that Kimura on that right side. He's going to use the same thing. It's deja vu, the same moves keep happening. Look for Deliga to bridge out of this.
Ground and pound now as Pacio postures up. Deliga tries to throw the legs up. Pacio doing some damage. Elbows now to the forehead from Joshua Pacio. These will score well for the young gun. Deliga's nowhere to go. Final seconds of the opening round. Dominance here from Joshua Pacio. Mount position. Deliga's almost gives his back.
One too many times. Deliga went to the well, trying that hip bridge to get out. Pacio finally figured it out on the fourth attempt. Was able to settle his hips and really just trap Deliga in that position. Look at some of these kicks by Pacio. It looks like he's swinging a baseball bat at Deliga. Here's that Kimura. Check this out. It's such a beautiful submission attempt. And Deliga is like, nope, nope. But he gets the sweep to end up on top. Check it out. Here it is. Deliga tries to bridge out and escape from these elbows just being rained down. As he tries to bridge, Pacio settles his hips down and traps Deliga. Wonderful. As you can see, Pacio is slowly starting to learn what Deliga is doing. Now it is his chance, if he does go back to the ground, to use the information that he's got to finish this contest, if he can get it back down to the mat.
Here, ready to rock and roll. Second round, set for three. Impressive in the opener was 21-year-old Joshua Pacio. Young man who began training in martial arts as a 12-year-old. Won several national wushu tournaments in the Philippines before transitioning to competing professionally in the cage. Was actually overweight as a child and credits martial arts for helping him to shed the excess pounds and turn him into the elite athlete he is today. Let's see if DeLegas can get his hands off here. And indeed, that's how he opened up the second stanza.
Just barely gives him a buzz cut on that right kick again. But DeLegas counters nicely with that left hook to the body.
Counter right hook there from DeLegas. The southpaw once again controlling center cage. Pacio on the outside, turning back kick. Uchidogeri from Joshua Pacio. DeLegas edges forward. Does have that one punch. Precision. So to Pacio. Joshua Pacio back in the winner's circle.
That was superb. Out of nowhere, Joshua Pacio closes the show. Beautifully done. Turns the lights out. Look at this. Misses. Spinning back fist right on the button. Goes low with the leg kick. Follows it around. The guard is down.
It's just when we said DeLegas had one punch KO power, just as we said it, Joshua Pacio, one punch KO, good night Roy DeLegas, a spinning back fist of the highest order.
Pacio does it all. Not only can he grind on you and finish you with the ground and pound and submissions, but now we're seeing the knockout power of Joshua the Passion Pacio.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chen, has put a stop to this contest after 38 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Joshua Pacio!
Pacio says he wants to test the stand-up of the Sanda champion. He wants to utilize that push kick and his big 1-2 combination to really see what the defense like is of Lan Ming Chang.
Lan Ming Chang wants to keep the contest on the feet. Pacio will test the striking, look for the takedown, and hope to sub him with a rear naked or a guillotine. Lan Ming Chang did say, I'll knock him out in one round. It was a bold prediction from the Chinese martial artist who lands an inside thigh kick. Pacio has got to have his defenses on the money. So too his counter-striking here, Mitch.
So he's trying to time it, catches the low kick, transitions into a nice body clinch. It's a bad spot for Lan Ming Chang to be in. He's got to create a little bit of movement. He throws his leg up, crosses it over his own leg, and that kind of prevents Joshua Pacio from sliding the knee onto his belly.
Let's see how Lan Ming Chang handles the ground. Off his back here, the Chinese cuts the hip into Pacio, drops the elbows to the ear of the Chinese martial artist. Here come the knees to the rib cage.
This is what we thought was going to be the difference maker in this match, is the grappling of Joshua Pacio. Typically with Sanda artists, you see them throw somebody and then they back off because that was a point scored. They don't typically stay on the ground. But with Joshua Pacio, he has a well-rounded ground game. Now he's on top, dropping a little bit of the elbows, trying to soften him up. Ooh, he steps over in the mouth. This is a bad spot for Lan Ming Chang.
Great finds the legs, and he did so easily there, Joshua Pacio. What a ground display so far from Pacio.
Lan Ming Chang's got to let go of that body lock he's got. He's got to create a little bit of space. You can see the hips of Joshua Pacio are pressing down. And that's kind of neutralizing Lan Ming Chang from moving away.
Round and pound here, still from the mount position from Joshua Pacio. Postures up now. There's the elbow. Turns the knuckles in off the right hand. Here are the elbows up the left from Pacio.
Elbows, punches coming. standing chunks, trying to bridge out, but he's got to let go of the body lock on Pacio.
Big elbow again from Joshua Pacio. Just past the halfway point of the opening round, and it's dominance here from the young Filipino.
Good hip pressure. He's got his legs sprawled out. He's pressing down on his hips. See that hip pressure? Mamichan can't go anywhere. Now he's looking for possibly an arm triangle, but he's got to give up, mount, and go over to the other side.
Survived. And Pacio, it's all one-way traffic. Still in the full mount. How does Lan Ming Chung get out of this match?
He's got to push off the hips and start bumping and elevate the hips of Joshua Pacio and then slide his hips out. He's got a bad spot. He's choosing to defend the strikes. If you're in that spot, you know you're going to get hit. He's got a great scramble. He's trying to move.
This kid is amazing. He puts everything together so well. He uses ground control to cause damage, to make his opponent turn his back.
Joshua Pacio, the most emphatic of victories. The very way he predicted it, the talent at that age to do that is amazing. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Jeff Andres, Property President of City of Dreams, Manila. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 1 second in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke, Joshua Pacio.
Very accomplished strikers. We might see the GoDaddy knockout of the night here, Michael.
Hey, indeed. Both men predict the finishes. Pacio says triangle submission. Pongsuri Mitsudit says KO overhand right. The power Mitsudit packs in that right hand is ungodly. Looks for the inside leg to Pacio. Mitsudit. Looks like he's leaned up a little for this one match.
Yeah, he spent a lot of time out there at Tiger Muay Thai getting ready for this matchup. And he says that he incorporated a little bit more strength and conditioning than usual into his program. We got the Muay Thai style of Mitsati going against that Filipino Wushu style of Joshua Pacio. Contrast of style should make for an
attack. Up for the first time. Just bouncing around this massive arena, and we're about 90% full.
Heavy Pacio tried to hit bump, but Pacio remained heavy and was able to transition into mount. This is where those submission skills are going to come in real handy with Pacio. Full mount, has the legs, great find, soften him up.
This place will be jam-packed in about 20 minutes, half an hour's time. And they are watching Joshua Pacio in control, full mount on Ponsari Mitsotid in the opening round. There's the right hand from Pacio. Already one win on the board tonight for a Team Philippines, courtesy of Rene Catalan with an upset over Stoppel Lahadian. Drops the elbows now to Pacio. Here comes the Filipino power. Breaks the elbow again.
One triangle. Let's see if he transitions over into the other side, but...
He predicted submission by triangle, Mitch. Can it be prophetic here for Pacio?
See, he's trying to get that arm underneath. This is what he's been working on. Mitsotid's got to just kind of, you know, ignore the posture and put his hands on the hips to elevate Pacio.
That's the ground and pound from Pacio. Mitsotid in trouble. The elbow. Look at him posture up again. This place goes crazy. It's definitely
Pacio. He's trying to scramble. This might
Pacio looking to send Manila into a meltdown in the last match of our prelim.
If you look at the right, you see that left hand of Pacio is underneath the cradling that arm there. So we can use the right hand to try to get underneath the chin. Close. Might be a little bit too high. He needs to settle down a little bit lower.
Mitsotid is undefeated, 9-0. He may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss.
Look at Joshua Pacio.
He is! Pacio tops him up! And then we're going to
melt down. We got a roll-up and then submission. He was in the back position. Controlling the left hand of Mitsotid. Chicken wing? What was that? That was beautifully done. What creativity from Joshua Pacio.
Mitch Chilson making up moves. A rear naked chicken wing is what the Dragon has dubbed it here. Here it is, Mitch.
Take a look at this. Oh, it's not doing, the angle is not doing it justice. Look at this, how he has the arm and then he cranks it completely back.
Oh, pay it, Mitch, rear naked chicken wing.
Maybe we could call it a reverse Kimura. I don't know what that was, but look at that. His arm, his hand almost touched the back of his head.
My word. Let's go to Dominic Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Nathan Sorensen, Director, Marketing Operations, City of Dreams. And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 37 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of arm lock, Joshua Pacio!
Championship gold here tonight. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. It's Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set. This one for the big one. Left hook early from Joshua Pacio in the red, and an outside thigh kick from the Filipino. This match brought to you by UC 1000, lemon water and orange water, rehydrate and protect.
You can see Joshua Pacio has a little bit lower stance than usual, has his hands a little bit lower, possibly looking to defend the takedown with underhooks and sprawl a bit heavy. He's immediately starting to attack the legs of Naito because I think he saw that Alex Silva was able to exploit the leg kicks in the title match that Naito lost. So he's using a lot of leg kicks because he knows that this might be a weakness for Nobita.
Pacio did say that Naito's striking would be his undoing. And you see Naito trying to get this contest to ground. Good sprawl out there from Pacio. Throws a knee. Nicely done from the Filipino. Bounce back up to his feet, and Angel breaks off. Just got out of the waiver. Bolo scooping up a cut there from Pacio.
Pacio looks extremely relaxed. That was a telegraph takedown. Easy sprawl by Pacio.
Naito went for a low single, Sakuraba style. Good counter there from Pacio. The heavy artillery off the hands. Would he become the fourth Team Lakai world champion? For Liang, Stuckrio, Benario. The next name beat Pacio. Okay, fifth actually, Kevin Bellignon too. Fifth Team Lakai world champion, so many of them. It's incredible success. Bellignon, who will be against PPR commanders in Singapore in November. There's a great shot from Pacio. He spoils out. Here come the right hands from the Filipino. The aggression early on from the Patron.
I think he hurt him with that body kick. You can see him wilt a little bit. Pacio went to the left hook to the body. Now he was attacking the whole body again on the ground.
What a start here from Joshua Pacio.
This match is starting to look a lot like their first encounter.
What was the undoing of Pacio 2 years ago, Mitch?
He made one mistake. He was in there for a takedown, and immediately you could see that Naito jumped on the back, sunk in that rear naked choke. One minor mistake on Pacio's part, and the night's over. But Pacio, he's now attempting to take Naito's back.
He said he'd like to do the passion lock. To do that, he's going to take Lopez's back. He's going to put him in a rear naked choke and then sink in the chicken wing.
Look at the way he's setting up that arm. He gave an instructional video on onefc.com, or the One Super app, for this exact move. He's controlling the underside on that arm. He's got the underhook. Now he's going to try to threaten the choke and then pull that arm back.
Is he setting up the passion lock on Naito? That would be incredible. Joshua Pacio, the 22-year-old, dominating here in the first round. Under mixed martial arts rules, our global rule set for the World Strawweight Championship. Taking his time, thinking it through here, Pacio. Where does Nobita go from here?
Well, he's got to turn into him. He's using the cage. He might want to try to spin around, but he's got one hand controlling on that side. Now you can see him, he's trying to go chest to chest. He does a good job of that, but Pacio sprawls very heavy. Good defense by Pacio. Naito can't reach the legs like that. He's got to set that up a little bit more carefully.
Already a lot of riveting on the back of the knees of Naito, courtesy of the leg kicks from Pacio. 50 seconds remaining. First round set for five. Takedown attempt here from Naito. Pacio sprawls out, tries to trap him in a choke attempt here. Naito out of trouble, looks for a head kick on the breakoff.
Good job by Pacio. He saw that overhand right. He knew that's how Naito likes to enter the takedowns, and he sprawled very heavily. Did it again. He threw that overhand right, goes in for the entry, goes after the legs. Pacio knew it was coming, sprawled heavily, but now he's got his hips up against the cage. Now it's gonna be a little harder for him to sprawl. He's gonna try to take that single leg, but I think he's gonna run out of time.
You get the feeling that Naito might like to try to drag this one to deep water. Naito has been to the fifth round four times in his career.
Look at Pacio looking nice and relaxed. Ate a bit of a high kick there, but immediately answered back with a nice little hook, straight hook combination. Pacio attacks the body, but I think before that, before he got hurt, he threw a nice kick to the body, and that was initially what did the damage. He lunged in there.
Round two. Chop. Champion Naito in the navy blue.
Ooh, beautiful time knee right as Naito is coming in. Bingo, hit him with a right knee.
Roundhouse kick to the rib cage there from Pacio. Nobito took some punishment to the legs, and there goes Pacio back to that lead thigh of the champion. Wasn't a great opening round for Nobita. Tries to thread the right hand, sprawls out as Pacio. Locks onto a single leg now does Naito. What can he do from here, Mitch? What are the options?
If these relentless attacks from Naito, he's consistently attacking after the legs. Joshua's got to be very careful here. He's trying to suck in the leg right here. So you can see him controlling the ankle, the left ankle of Pacio, who's going to try to pull that foot away from
Joshua Pacio and put his butt onto the mat just like that. Now he's gonna roll up. Joshua's doing a good job of defending here.
All tied up like a pretzel here in the second round. This is what Nobita does so well. Always thinking, always planning, always plotting. The champion. And what's going on there with the leg of Nobita?
Good job by Joshua. You can see he was trying to get sucked in. Nobita was trying to pull the legs in, but Joshua's hips are so heavy, he was able to control the position. Now he pushes off. Back to the feet.
Nobita edges forward again, the champion. Right of screen, body shot there from Pacio, going for the bridge basket. Goes the head kick on Nobita. Beautifully done from the Pacio. Overhand right, goes for a shot. Good sprawl out again from Pacio. Nice takedown defense. Fake right hand there from Nobita. Very wide stance on the champion. Goes to the body. Sprawl out again from Pacio, doing everything right so far in defense here, Mitch.
That he is doing, because, and remember, it's just like in the first exchange these two had. It was two rounds, Joshua was stopping the takedowns. Look at this, he's taking the back now, setting up that possible passion lock again.
Mitch, talk us through the passion lock again. What's the mechanics of it? What happens in the passion lock?
Well, what he's doing right now, he's got the back, he's got both hooks in. He controls the underside arm with his underhook. So he has that underhook on the right side of Nobita. Now, he's gonna threaten the choke to get Naito thinking about the choke, but he's really aiming for that hand. Now he doesn't really quite have the wrist yet. Pacio is trying to control the wrist on the right side, but he's also trying to threaten the choke. And that's what he's gonna do. He's gonna pull the arm behind when Naito's thinking about the choke, and he's gonna try to Kimura it basically into a chicken wing and crank on that shoulder. It's an extremely painful move. He was trying to take the arm completely off Pongsui Mitsati when he locked it in.
He called it the rear naked chicken wing. He dubbed it the passion lock on the night. It's become one of the viral sensations online. So many thousands of fans have watched the passion lock from Joshua Pacio. And he seems to be in control again here in the second round. Nobita, the champion, maybe looking for a way back to his feet. He posts up on the right arm, and Pacio keeping him down.
A few people, Michael, have called it a hammer lock, but I like the passion lock much better.
Right hand transitions into a takedown attempt, and top position now for Pacio. This is some good stuff we're seeing from Joshua Pacio of the Philippines, Mitch.
He is definitely seizing the moment here tonight. But, I mean, these are the things, these are the small little things, these small little mistakes. At any moment, Naito can jump on your back and choke you out. That he does this so well. He lures people into a false sense of security, and right when you think you're fully, you know, you're winning the match, boom, it's over, and you're going to sleep.
Butterfly hooks now from Pacio. 45 seconds remaining, second round of five of this mixed martial arts main event for the Strawweight Championship of the World. Japan versus the Philippines, Naito and Pacio. Inside the guard of Pacio now. Naito top position. What can he do from here? He drops an elbow across the jawline. Good work from Nobita. Goes to the body with the left hand.
Naito likes to draw people into deep water and then suffocate them. And that's what he's doing right here. You know, he might have lost these first two rounds, but now we're starting to see that championship experience. You know, how many times has he been in the fourth and fifth round? He does his best work in that deep water.
He's been to the fourth or the fifth round, I should say, four times in his career. Here's the ground. Pacio off his back. What a round. We go to the towels once again. Third round of five in our championship main event.
You can see Naito looks a little bit more aggressive, looks a little bit more agitated.
Beautiful popping right hand to start there from Pacio. Sprawls out. Now Pacio on his back trying to execute a choke here.
Nice little takedown there, though. Joshua went down a little bit without much of a fight at all, but this is where Naito really starts to excel. He starts to just grind on his opponents, outworking his opponents on the ground, landing little shots. He controls the hips very well of his opponents, consistently sucking in their hips, controlling their movement.
Top position for the champion.
Yoshitaka Naito, the comic book lover from Japan. Lost the title to Alex Silva, won it back in the rematch. This, another rematch from 2 years ago. On that occasion, Naito the victor. Pacio believes he can sink the passion lock on the champ to take the gold back to Baguio City. A very hard ask against the guy as good on the ground as Yoshitaka Naito.
Good job of Pacio to get out of the guard and gets, now he has got these underhooks here. He's able to use them to get out of the position. Good job from Pacio.
Inside leg kick from Pacio. Nicely done to that back leg. Orthodox stance on both men. Naito faking and fainting. Can he get the hands off here? The champion goes in for a double leg. Couldn't execute a takedown. Good defense again from Pacio. Locks onto a single, does Naito.
Look at the way he sucked in that leg, Michael. He was able to trap that leg, use his own leg to sweep it underneath and use that to get Pacio onto the ground.
Although Naito not always successful on his takedown attempts here, Mitch, is he the aggressor, constantly going for the takedowns against Pacio?
Well, we score in two ways, Michael. We score with takedown defense and we score in takedowns. So if Joshua Pacio is able to stop the takedowns, it's gonna disrupt Naito's scoring. But if Naito consistently hunts for him and he transitions, he chain wrestles, so he's going for multiple takedowns, it's gonna score as well. So they both score, but takedowns score a little bit higher than takedown defense.
We are now halfway through the match, our main event here in Jakarta. Wherever you're watching, in 138 countries around the world, we hope you're loving every moment of this martial arts magnificence. Half guard position one for Joshua Pacio in the red trunks from the Philippines. Can he land some ground and pound? Where does the beater go from here?
Oh, Michael, you missed it though, but in that transition, Pacio was able to use a butterfly sweep to end up on top. So you could see Naito trying to apply pressure from the top position, and Pacio was able to utilize an underhook on the leg, sweep him up over and change the position. But that's the grappling of Naito to get back on top.
You know my mistake, Mitch? I blinked, and these two guys are so damn fast on the ground. You can't even blink. You take your eyes off them for a millisecond, and they're doing something crazy.
Man, let those eyes dry out. You don't want to miss any of this action, because Naito's back on top, doing what he does best, grinding, outworking his opponents.
So what does Pacio do off his back here?
Pacio, he's trying to push off the hips, you know, so he's trying to keep a very active guard. He's not just keeping his guard closed, attempting, you know, to hold on to Naito, waiting for a stand-up. From here, you can see him consistently push. Now he's got the butterfly hooks, and he's going to try to trap one arm and sweep him to one side, or put the feet on the hips and push away.
Obita has become a master of decision wins. He's got six of them in his career. Now Pacio would like to finish the champion, to claim the gold, to take it back to Baguio City, to inspire the uninspired in the Philippines, just like his heroes, Edward Filaing and Manny Pacquiao. 40 seconds remaining, third round of five. This has been a fantastic contest on the ground.
Pacio's only got two blemishes on his record, and they've come both from Japanese athletes by rear naked choke. So that's been his Achilles heel. And you can see Naito's trying to collapse the legs. He's trying to push the legs down and pass the guard. But Pacio's really shown improvements in his guard. His ability to keep his legs in front of his opponents and keep them wrapped around his body.
Naito can finish you at any moment. When he won the Shooto strawweight title in 2014, he submitted Shinya Murafuji with just 3 seconds remaining in the fifth round. Now we are getting into that deep water.
So you blinked, Michael, so let's take a look at it here. Look at the guard of Pacio. He's able to control the feet on the hips, and he's looking to get one leg inside. You can see one foot underneath the leg right here. Right here, that left leg, he elevates him up, and he sweeps him over. Beautifully done butterfly sweep right there from Pacio.
Ready?
Choke! Here we go, fourth of five, mixed martial arts global rule set. And Pacio comes out with a left hook.
Haven't really seen Nobita get his best strikes off tonight as we did see him last time against Alex Silva in their rematch. Fakes a leg kick to Nobita. Takes a leg kick from Pacio.
This is uncharted water for Pacio. He's never seen a fourth round. He's never been into the championship rounds. But he's doing a good job so far of stopping this takedown and landing some significant strikes of his own.
How many hours do you think they trained the sprawling of Joshua Pacio in the lead up to this one, Mitch?
You know, Team Lakai has been criticized for years that the grappling game is their Achilles heel, but now we're starting to see some huge improvements from every single one of their athletes on the ground.
One of the powerhouse teams in all of Asia, indeed in the martial arts world, Team Lakai. Look at the champions they boast. Edward Falayan, Jeha Yastakrio, Kevin Bellignon, Honorio Benario, all have held or do hold world titles. That is amazing for the team from Baguio City in the Philippines.
Can you imagine what their walls must look like? Just covered in belts.
Body shot there from Naito, falls short. Body shot from Pacio, fires the uppercut. Outside leg kick. A shade of red on the lead thigh of Yoshitaka Naito. In fact, it's now a kaleidoscope of color. Taking some punishment courtesy of that back shin of Joshua Pacio. Nobita not committing to the roundhouse kick. And again, Pacio finds the mark on the lead quadricep. That leg's got to be hurting Nobita. And that leg damage will make it harder for Nobita to shoot in on Pacio.
You know, he just did right there, and he's able to get that single leg beautifully done. Little turnaround takedown off the single leg there for Naito. Pacio's trying to hold onto the head, trying to elevate him now. But we're seeing some like superior striking from Pacio earlier.
Okay, Mitch, we're almost midway through the fourth round of five. Let's play coach again. What are you telling Nobita to do right now?
Nobita, he's got to show, he's got to show ground control. He's able to get Pacio down, so he's A, he's scoring the takedowns, but B, he's not advancing his position, and that's what shows ground control. You can see he hasn't been able to get past the guard. I might have spoke too soon as he's knifing that knee right through the guard there of Pacio, but Pacio does a beautiful job of maintaining the guard. So he's got to advance his position. He's got to do damage. He's got to show aggression by landing some ground and pound, and he's got to advance his position.
And what would Mark and Team Lagai be telling Joshua Pacio right now with just under 2 minutes remaining in the penultimate round?
Pacio's doing a beautiful job on the ground here. Look at him, he's attempting to go for Kimuras. He's consistently attacking. He's trying to maintain the position, but I think he really wants to get up, just like he did now, but he made a slight mistake. Good little scramble, but he is able to get back up to his feet. Beautiful dive.
Naito wants to put him down again. Oh, look at the elbows on the collarbone there of Naito. And Pacio on his back again. What can the champion do from here? Top position for Yoshitaka Naito.
Nice little transition from Naito, but again, he's not able to get past the guard of Pacio. Now he's into half guard, so now he's going to try to flatten out that arm. There's a possible arm triangle here on that side, but Pacio's got to keep his arm underneath, try to get underneath the head there. That's what he's doing. Good job. But while he's doing that, Naito's taking that leg out.
Mitch, what do you see as the biggest threat for Joshua Pacio?
At the moment, there's not a lot. You know, Naito is not doing a lot as far as ground and pound. You know, he's not able to advance his position, so he can't get past the guard of Pacio. But his biggest mistake, or his biggest possible mistake, is to make one minor error. And that's where Naito really starts to excel and shows that championship medal is by capitalizing on any mistake that you're going to make.
Inside Pacio's guard, the flurry of ground and pound from Yoshitaka Naito. And Pacio trying to create some distance. Rattles punches to the side of the champion's head. Tries to control his posture. Closes up the guard now. Naito trying to blast his way up. Trying to posture up and land the ground and pound. Ferocious stuff here from the champion. Good work from Naito. Body shots there from Naito and reverse elbows from Pacio. What a way to end this round. We're going to go into the fifth and final. It's the deepest of deep water. It's somewhere Pacio has never been before.
Wow, just at the bell. I don't know how the judges are gonna score that. Look at some of the beautiful work here from Pacio, landed a nice little combination, exiting on the hook. But here's Naito on top, trying to work past the guard, and then just at the moment, look at that. He goes out the back door, right, he was about to give up mount.
And how about the champion? What does he have to do for the next 5 minutes?
The champion's got to get this to the ground, and he's got to do damage. He's got to do significant damage to Pacio on the ground, maybe on the feet here, but he's got to do something big.
And already you see a little more pepper, a little more mustard out of Yoshitaka Naito. There's a certain gusto about the champion now. A high kick from Pacio. Nobita working angles, those awkward angles, the little quarter turns, the little pirouettes. It's the fifth round of our world title main event, Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set in action. Outside leaking from Pacio. Nobita in center cage. Pacio tried to scoop the right hand. Will the gold go back to Japan? Will it go to the Philippines?
Yeah, we're pretty close either way, but we're starting to see Naito definitely has a little bit more urgency behind a lot of these engagements. You know, he's starting to push forward, and Pacio's slowing down just a little bit, and just as I said that, he lands a big knee. Look at the sacrifice. What he does is he pulls guard into the half guard, and now he's able to get control of the hips. Let's see if he can reverse him.
Top position here for Pacio. Could he find a sub from this position? The 22-year-old from Baguio City in the Philippines goes onto his back here. Top position now for Nobita.
Great reversal there from Naito. He was able to get that single leg, transition out, get back on top. It's a bad spot for Pacio to be in.
So what are the options for the champion here, Mitch?
Well, you can probably wait a little bit. Oh, look at that, look at it. Beautifully done, minor mistake. He was trying to pass the half guard into mount, and Pacio was able to slide out, end up on top, and get out.
Nobita wants Pacio on the canvas. There he goes now. Pacio trying to sink some sort of choke attempt. Nobita looking to pass the guard, goes there. Well done from the champion. What's Nobita looking for here, Mitch?
You can see Joshua is trying to get the legs around one of the legs. So he's trying to catch a leg to get back into half. And that was the battle right there. But Naito looks to be winning it right there on the right leg. Pacio's trying to get back into the half guard, but good job by Naito to nullify that.
Once again, Yoshitaka Naito has been to the fifth round now 5 times in his career. This is very familiar territory. Pacio before tonight had never been past a third round.
Well,
this is usually where Naito is so strong, where he usually powers up, where he usually owns opponents in the fifth, the final, the championship round.
Good scrambles by Pacio, but I think he gave up the mount. He's back in half guard. Yup, he's back in half guard, but look at the way Naito is able to float around. Almost back in that side control, but good job by Pacio to pull him back into guard to stop the advancing of position from Naito. But he hops over, now he's back into a possible side control, but a good sweep there from Pacio.
Pacio hunting after the left arm of Nobita. Can he find something here? The pressure! The pressure! Can he take home that arm? If he takes it home, he'll take home the gold as well. But no, Nobita seems to be okay.
Well, that's kind of, it's going to be really hard. All he can do to use this kimura for is a sweep to control the position.
What to finish?
Naito might try to roll the other way. And he does, and he gets up and continually attacks the leg.
The high IQ of the champion gets him out of that predicament. And now Nobita looking to take it to ground. They go there. What does Pacio do from here, Mitch?
Well, he's trying to push his head away to create a little bit of space and not give up side control. Naito looks to be getting pretty close to it. Yep, now he's got side control. Good advance on the position from Naito. Pacio's going to scramble, though, try to get out. And he does. Attacks the leg.
Back up under their feet. Final minute, fifth and final round. Drops down to take the legs from under Pacio. Pacio trying to maintain his vertical base. What a thrilling, gripping final round of action. Indeed, this entire World Championship main event has been extraordinary. 40 seconds on the clock now, Mitch.
Look at that back and forth action from both these guys. Naito is continually trying to pass the guard, but look at Pacio able to keep the guard in place and battle for the last 20 seconds.
This one's gonna go down the wire. I'd hate to be a judge. It's so close. It's razor thin. What a contest between two superb martial artists. And look at the replay.
There was a little bit of a light touch on the leg kick, but Pacio was able to counter with a leg kick of his own. Add a big left hook to punctuate that exchange. Here's Naito continually scrambling, always looking for something, always trying to move forward, has that ground control. Look at this, he's able to end up on top in the exchange, goes after the leg again.
New World Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio!
Saruta in the black trunks, Pacio the Filipino in the red. Pacio, one of five Filipino world champions in the men's division Tier 1 championship. They are the dominant country, and he is the youngest world champion. Oh, head kick came close there from Pacio, and we're on the ground for the first time.
First little tango here on the ground is going to tell us a lot. Pacio's now in guard. Let's see what Saruta can do. If he's just going to choose to soften him up, keep him there, or is he going to try to pass and advance his position for the ground control?
Could Pacio possibly find a way somewhere in this contest to take the back seated on Saruta and employ the passion lock? It is spectacular. It was voted the 2019 Submission of the Year. Saruta, two submissions, five knockouts and 18 victories. Last time out, defeated former world champion Alex Silva by unanimous decision. That was a one championship debut.
It's a methodical approach so far from Saruta. He very quietly punched, stepped over into the half guard. Now he's flattening out. Pacio needs to try to get to his hips. That's what he's doing. He's trying to move to his side for a little bit of space. He's got to sit on the left side of his body so he can start to angle out and get away. All of Team Nakai is extremely explosive. We like to power out of moves, explode as their preferred form of escape. Kevin Bellingham is a perfect example of that. Right now, Pacio's got an underhook on the right side. So now he's going to keep and use that to slip even more onto his side.
Pacio, who usually looks for every opportunity to get to his feet and employ his sensational strikes, is keeping it on the ground at the moment. Top position here for Saruta, the Japanese champion. Tries to make a guillotine there, did Pacio, with no avail.
Good job by Pacio to get almost back to full guard, had a butterfly hook in there, but Saruta was able to step over and get back into half guard now. Again, Pacio's doing all the right things. He's hip escaping, but he moves his hip to the outside, tries to get sit on his left side so he can start creating space.
Saruta looking to posture up and drop an elbow between the arms of the champion. Pacio looking for a way back to his feet. Is he going to get there?
Nice job by Pacio to create a little bit of a scramble. Now he's got Saruta pressed up against the cage.
Chance to see the Wushu striking of one world champion, Joshua Pacio.
Interesting guard from Saruta. See how he angles his hand? He's like almost dead arming his arm up by his head, covering his elbow with his face, dropping his left hand down to his side.
A very cagey and tremendously strong customer is the challenger, Yosuke Saruta. This the main event of ONE Championship's first show in 2019. It's Eternal Glory. From inside Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia.
I'm not sure I've ever seen that stance before. The buttons, you know.
Hitting with that elbow.
Trying to come up underneath. Throw an Anderson Silva type elbow, or is he trying to throw a reverse hammer fist? A reverse hammer fist?
If he gets a reverse fist off of him, also a stepping back elbow would be better the case from the stance he's employing. We aren't seeing those coming Wushu side kicks from Joshua Pacio that we're used to. Look out, Saruta races back to center cage. There's that strange, awkward stance of his open guard of Yosuke Saruta. Under a minute remaining.
kind of leaves the body open to that right side body kick. Pacio could throw a roundhouse right to the body, but I don't know if he wants to do that because Saruta might catch it and take him down again.
Pacio, the first of the guys, four world champions to defend in 2019. Next Friday night at the Hall of Major Arena in Manila, Jay Hayastakia puts his world title on the line against Brazil's Adriano Moraes. And then March 31st in Tokyo, Edward Falayang puts his strap on the line against Shuga Aoki. High up on the balls of his feet here, the champ, Joshua Pacio.
Final 10 seconds, a takedown here might be perfectly timed for Saruta just to kind of... Nice little leg kick there thrown by Pacio.
A jumping roundhouse kick, must skip up on it there from Joshua Pacio. We go to the towels at the end of one.
There's that awkward stance shown by Saruta. He throws that head kick, bomb, lands just ever so off the top of the head there. As he goes up top to the head, Saruta was able to get on top.
For the one strawweight world title, the holder in the red, Joshua Pacio of the Philippines. Saruta would love to put Pacio on his back again. Works some ground and pound. Try to find a submission. Let's see if Pacio can employ some of those side kicks. Let's see if he can pull the trigger on his right hand.
It's almost like Pacio's a bit hesitant to kick. Doesn't necessarily want to leave anything open, leave anything for Saruta to grab onto.
Pacio goes for the legs. Saruta thrusts out the lead hand. Lead hand, as we mentioned in the opening round, is very strangely positioned, forming the guard of the challenger.
Pacio quite hasn't found his range yet. He's trying to just kick to open up the exchanges. Hasn't put a lot of hands yet. There's a nice little takedown. I like how Saruta changes and chain wrestles. He consistently goes for one takedown after another. A little bit high up on the body lock here. I see him drop down, change levels, but that overhook on the right side of Pacio is preventing Saruta from really dropping down. Now he might be able to step over.
He twists like a mini tornado, knee there from Pacio. He's backed against the cage here. Both men trading knees. Pacio off the left, Saruta off the right leg. Inside knee, trying to cork up that thigh there, Yosuke Saruta. Where does Pacio go from here, Mitch?
He's got an overhook on that right side, so he's trying to turn out to the right, but it's hard because Saruta's got an underhook on that side, so it kind of enables him to have a slight advantage. Saruta lets him go again. Shows the exit on the knee. He feels more comfortable out in the middle of the ring, or the cage, rather, than having him up against the cage.
Saruta leading with that left elbow once more. Jab two from the Japanese. Counter right hand there from the Filipino. A left roundhouse kick from Pacio. Goes to the body, looping punches. A little wild on the execution there, Saruta. Two world champions in the cage. And Saruta the challenger for the one world title. Pacio the defending champion in the red. Saruta winning on one championship debut last time out. Many would consider it an upset if he beats Pacio tonight, but there's a lot of pundits out there who think Saruta can do it, thinks he has the necessary tools. High kick from Pacio, and that had some starch behind it.
That high kick is there. Saruta's not doing a lot to deflect that high kick because of that weird guard that's enabling not to be able to get his hand up around to block the high kick. His hand has to do a complete 180-degree turn to get his hand up to block his head. He can't block those with just his shoulder and his elbow.
You know what would work very well against this guy, Mitch? A good old-fashioned Brazilian kick, aka a question mark kick.
I think it would. Maybe start attacking the legs, go after the leg kicks, and then bop, go up top.
Pacio fakes the kick toward the lead elbow, the lead forearm of Saruta, and then loops it over the top of the left shoulder. Question mark, picking up, nice little digging uppercut there from Pacio.
Nice, scoop underneath, came up, chin up a little bit of Pacio, looking good with the hands so far. Now he's starting to get a little bit more comfortable, letting things go. But Pacio's letting Saruta go first. He's countering off of what Saruta's doing. That could just be because of his forward pressure. Saruta's consistently pushing forward.
What we are seeing at the moment in this world title match is a very close contest. Saruta shoots in for the takedown. They're on the canvas now with 45 seconds left in this round. Some acrobatics there, Saruta back to his feet.
His acrobatics, though, cost him the position. He tried to jump over the guard, and Pacio was able to escape away. But I think that takedown might have counted because his butt hit, but his back didn't fully hit, so the judges might not have given that takedown.
Outside leg kick from Pacio. Big hello to all of our Filipino fans watching live on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Also our Japanese fans watching live on Abima TV. Big right hand from Saruta. He loaded up with that one. Missed the target though. Trying to get off first with his punches. The Japanese challenger gets out of the hard kick. The headache maker from Pacio.
His timing's coming close. Nice little exchange there. There's that scooping uppercut that Pacio was able to land. Here, see his back doesn't quite hit the ground, so I don't know if the judges are going to allow that to score. You can see there he actually goes, so that might be counted as a takedown. You can see him try to cartwheel over.
The cross gets us underway. Some damage you saw in the corner under the eye of Pacio. Nothing serious though. Trying to catch Saruta coming in. Saruta didn't commit to any punches. Left hook there from the Japanese. Head movement from Saruta, changing levels. Cutting his angles here. Jabs his way in, but very awkward looking jab. Shoots him for a double leg, stops the takedown attempt. Does Pacio, nicely done from the champion. Oh, guillotine attempt from Pacio! What's Pacio got here, Mitch?
He's got a guillotine, but he's in half guard. He doesn't really quite have the angle. You can see how high the head of Saruta is. Pacio's got to create a little bit more, and he's got to get his hips a little bit higher. So he probably doesn't have it. He's going to have to let it go as he gas out his arms. What I'm most impressed with is the takedown defense of Pacio. Typically, Saruta does a very good turn. He turns the corner very well off the double leg, and Pacio is able to follow him around and stop that takedown. Let's see what he can do here off his back. He's got to dig on that underhook. But you see Saruta's cradling his leg right there. Pacio scrambles back up again. Good job, Pacio.
Let's see if the Filipino Pacio can get his strikes off now. I haven't seen much of the side kicks from Pacio. We're so used to. There's a roundhouse kick to the upper right ribs. Saruta, lead hand, just popped it to the tip of the nose. High kick from Pacio. Only the single strikes, though, from Joshua Pacio. Needs to start some combination work, but he is worried, as Mitch alluded to earlier, that Saruta may catch a kick and drive him to the canvas, take advantage.
These kicks to the left side of the body have been working very well for Saruta. I'd like to see him attack that leg. So start digging in, start attacking that leg, get Saruta thinking about that leg. And with that guard, boom, head up top, the head kick. Easier set than this position, easier set from that position.
There was a try for a catch and counter from Pacio.
Pacio seems to be counter-striking. He's waiting for Saruta to go first, and then he's coming back with shots of his own.
Is that a clever game plan from Pacio?
Well, he's scoring. He's landing. I don't know if how the judges are seeing this, but he is landing effectively.
Dangerous spin there from Pacio. Left hook misses for Saruta. 2 minutes 20 remains in the third round, set for five of our World Championship main event. From Astana Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia, it's Eternal Glory. One Championship's first show of 2019. Don't forget, next Friday night, we're at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Jay, how you stuck? We are in action. Main event, world title defense against Adriana Moraes. A fighting right hand to the kisser there from Saruta.
Saruta was able to catch that kick, but the footwork of Pacio was very effective. Even on one leg, he was able to keep maintain his balance and stifle the takedown attempt from Saruta.
Saruta edging forward. Elbow, the left elbow leading the way. It's very unique guard of his.
See, but he's, Pacio sees it too. He sees exactly what we do with that guard. He's going after the head. But Saruta has very good eyes. His reaction time is very quick.
Catching counter there from Saruta. Another tactic that Pacio could employ with that lead arm of Saruta so far extended, especially the elbow, Mitch, is good old-fashioned Muay Thai 101. Just kick the crap out of it. Just try and kick the humerus, kick the elbow over and over again, and break that arm down because it's hanging out there like a target awaiting to be struck.
But I think Saruta heard you, and he's starting to kick his hand up a little bit higher.
Let's speak a little softer here, Kateside. Inside leg kick attempt there from Saruta. Pacio could really go to town on that lead arm. Pacio forearm, that wrist, cracks and roundhouse kicks. See if Saruta doesn't bring that arm back or drop it completely, leaving him exposed on that left side.
John jump turning back kick.
Pacio in
jumping roundhouse kick. He stunned him, and there's the right hand from Pacio. And now the power elbows from the strawweight world champion.
Pacio channeling his inner Kevin Ballignon with a jump turning back kick.
I like how he changes it up and starts going to the other side of the body. Not just going after the head, not just going after the legs, but the left side of his body, spinning and attacking and going after the center of his body. Good job, Joshua Pacio.
An aggressive end to the round from Pacio Dragon, and the crowd appreciated it here in Jakarta.
Look at that, again. Silva allowed Saruta to go first, countered with a hook of his own. Beautifully timed shot there from Joshua Pacio. There he is going airborne, attacking the other side of Saruta's body, landing connected just ever so slightly on that, with that knee, that jumping switch kick through there.
There's something that really worries me, Mitch, about Pacio, is he's tending to throw the spinning back fist with more frequency, but he's a little slow on it. And we all know what happened to his teammate Edward Folayan against Martin Nguyen. You can't make the same mistake against Saruta and be a little too slow on the spinning back fist, and Saruta may catch him in that spin around.
Well, the biggest thing, the difference I see between these two is that Martin Nguyen has impeccable timing and footwork. I'm not seeing the same sort of timing and footwork from Saruta, so I don't think Pacio's as worried about it, but he does have a big right hand. Saruta does have power in that right hand, and he has knocked people out before with it.
All right, fighter. We enter what they call the championship round, and fittingly so, as two world champions square off.
A charging single leg takedown off the bell from Saruta. House on fire. He's going to up the aggression. He's going to up the mercury.
Pacio went for the hand touch, and Saruta ducked underneath it and shot in for a takedown. I don't know how I feel about that, but you gotta protect yourself at all times.
And Saruta top position. Oh, Pacio gets back to his feet. What a start to this penultimate round. The aggressive meter suddenly rises in Saruta's favor.
After a very good third round from Joshua Pacio, Saruta's got to step things up a little bit. Now we're in the championship rounds. Now we're in the rounds that are going to decide this match. And Saruta, he's been in those championship rounds. He's gone a full five before. He knows what this deep water is like.
The takedown there from Saruta. Put on the hips here from Joshua Pacio. Looks at the push off.
I like that. Good push there from Joshua Pacio to create a little bit of space, but not quite enough for him to get back up to his feet.
Saruta looks to pass. Locks onto a single here against Pacio.
Man, it's so hard to hold Joshua Pacio down. This is, Saruta was able to hold down and beat on Alex Silva. He's not able to do that to Joshua Pacio. Explosion from Team Makai.
Joshua Pacio beat a Japanese for the title. He will defend Yoshitaka Naito. And he brings another Japanese warrior here tonight in Yosuke Saruta. Joshua Pacio!
qualifiers remaining, fourth round of five, world strawweight title on the line, defending champion Joshua Pacio from the Philippines in the red. Yosuke Saruta, the challenger, also a world champion in his own right, in the black. Jab to a attempted takedown there for Saruta.
See, he's trying to turn the corner. He's trying to angle off to the right and get in there. He's attacking the single leg, trying to change direction. But Pacio's got that figured out. He has his number, and he's able to stop the takedown very effectively. Good cage control shown by Joshua Pacio, but he's got to do a little bit more, especially in this round. The first half of this fourth round looked to be all Saruta, but Pacio's doing a good job of dictating where this match is going.
Hooking right punch off the break there, Yosuke Saruta. He dances through it again. John Turman back kick from Pacio. That one was under the diaphragm. Saruta needs to commit here, and he does. Overhand right, this is the target. Good head movement from Pacio. Under 2 minutes remaining to the fourth.
Rather than trying to turn the corner on Saruta's takedown, maybe he might want to just blast right through the double leg. See how he keeps trying to do that knee tap? He's going up on the arm and then coming down with the leg, trying to throw Pacio out to the right. If he just goes through, cradles both legs and dumps him to the left, he might be more successful in his takedown because Pacio has that figured out.
Neither of these world champions are showing signs of fatigue, which we know that Pacio won't tire out of this one thing that Team Lakai is renowned for. It's the cardio, it's the gas tank, they can go on for days.
I've been through a conditioning session at Team Lakai, and it is something unreal.
Especially how high up are they there at Baghdad City?
Man, they are as high up in the mountains, like 4 hours uphill.
Skip inside thigh kick there from Saruta.
One of that in the foreground.
Saruta's trying to push forward now. Shadow boxing there just to get Pacio thinking about the hands. And he's going to shoot for another takedown here. He's creating that space.
Open's really wildly with the hands. So we'll turn the front foot now. Under 40 seconds remaining in this fourth round. A fake downstairs did Pacio. Then wanted to come and clip him over the top of the left hook.
Pacio's trying to time that takedown with a knee right there. Good takedown defense, but Saruta's able to clasp his hands. Gotta watch the arm and guillotine now. So we're just choosing to press him up against the cage. Interesting strategy from Saruta. I think he might feel the choke coming on. He gently sets him down.
Final seconds of the fourth round. We're gonna go into the deepest of deep water, the fifth and final in this world title main event. 10 feet. Above mean sea level of 1,466 meters, so pretty damn high.
That is some serious elevation. So when these guys, they've lived in that elevation, so that carries over for a long time. Sit on top and drop bombs on Pacio.
Champion versus champion. Striking versus grappling. Pacio and Saruta, and they open up with the acrobatics, with the heavy artillery. High kick there from Pacio, came close to looping the shin around the back of the neck. Saruta high on the balls of his feet, the head movement here from the Japanese warrior, goes downstairs to the legs, so too does Pacio. Quarterback going upstairs again, Pacio. Chance for up for the Filipino once more here in Indonesia.
And takedowns from Pacio, attempts. The defense from Pacio digs those underhooks, keeps Saruta up to maintain this match on his feet. But now he's got to go first. Throw those hands, punctuate with the kick.
Kick release on left hand there. Number one world champion, Joshua Pacio.
Telegraph takedown from Saruta.
Overhand right, Pacio. Through the uppercut, went so high, I heard organs playing. Saruta resets. Pacio edging forward. This Indonesian crowd has gotten behind the Filipino tonight. Did you expect that?
How can you not love Joshua Pacio? All he talks about is finding your passion, realizing your dreams, supporting the kids, people chasing their goals. How can you not fall in love with this kid? He's 22 and with world titles.
Amazing young man, Joshua Pacio.
is he 3 minutes and 25 seconds away from retaining his world title. Overhand right.
Nice right landed by Saruta. He's got to do more of that, but he's got to do something to dominate. I think he might be a little bit behind in the scorecards. I don't know if those takedowns are enough. Ooh, now he's trying to be aggressive.
Saruta swept through off the brow of Pacio. Oh, Pacio tried for a jumping knee, and then backed up against the cage in front of our commentary position.
I told you he was timing those takedowns a little bit. He saw Saruta coming in. Let's see if Saruta can take this down.
Booking knees of the thigh here from Saruta. Pacio, wrist control. Saruta getting instruction from his corner. So too, Mark Sanjiao yelling across at Joshua Pacio. Tries to drop down Saruta. Advancing right hand and now backs off halfway through this fifth and final round. Intriguing battle for the one strawweight world title in Jakarta, Indonesia. Oh, spinning back elbow from Pacio. And came within a whisker's length of connecting.
Different type of takedown. Pacio had his number on this, but watch Pacio trying to scramble back up. Oh, but he's in full mount now. But look at him scramble back up to his feet, Joshua Pacio.
The crowd loving it from Joshua Pacio. And now look at the Filipino do, the world champion, who is maybe 1 minute 40 away from retaining the crown.
Pacio says, I got takedowns too. I can control you on top.
Here, Jones keeping an eye on top of the action, making sure the work rate is flowing between these two. Two amazing martial arts, two incredible world champions, peaking in their powers. And careful not to strike the kidney area there, Saruta.
Pacio's got his hand clasped, so he has control of Saruta's hips, but that just shows you how good Saruta is and how heavy his hips is. He's got to try to push down on the head and work his way back up to his feet. He does not want to end the match in this position.
Pulls the legs out as Pacio gets back to his feet now, the Filipino. What's Pacio looking to do here, Dragon?
He was trying to turn the corner, but you see the way Saruta stepped over the leg, so Pacio, oh, he hits up the mouth. Oh, what power, what explosiveness from Joshua Pacio to get back up to his feet.
Tremendous back and forth action from these two world champions. 35 seconds on the clock now. Listen to this crowd. They're cheering for Joshua Pacio with a power.
These are two exceptional scramblers. They are moving so well. They never stay in one position for more than a couple seconds.
Saruta comes forward, throws the right hand as a lead pop. Jab team from Pacio, gets out of time. Saruta goes high, then grabs a hold of the legs, trying to plant Pacio, and he gets it down. Final 10 seconds, a chance for a late flurry of ground and pound from the Japanese. Goes for the right hand, Pacio raises the leg. A wild flurry on the ground.
We don't judge round by round, we judge a match on its entirety, based on the entire thing. Look at this, constant scrambling. No man was able to hold another man in one position for more than a couple seconds.
Mitch, I cannot call this one. It is so close. All I know is that we saw two phenomenal martial arts world champions.
New one strawweight world champion, Yosuke!
Up on the balls of his feet early, the champion, Saruta. A crucial striking of Joshua Pacio. Pacio, the former world champion. Saruta, the one world champion and Shooto world champion. Take there from Saruta. Switching stance between the knocks and southpaw here.
That's the low leg kicks of Joshua Pacio. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Saruta.
Now Mitch, Saruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90 degree angle guard we saw him use last time. Oh, turn it back kick! Smack bang in the guts from Joshua Pacio!
spinning back kick from Joshua Pacio. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more the mind games coming from the ninja. Doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Saruta, outside leg kick, overhand right again there from Saruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pacio here in Manila.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Saruta as he ends up in half guard.
Pacio receiving instruction from Mark Sanjao in the corner here from Team Legai. Half guard position for the champion. Controlling the posture here though, Pacio, not allowing Saruta to posture up and work that vicious ground and pound that he has. Patience here from Pacio, a stalemate move.
Saruta's got his head wrapped around, or his arm, his left arm wrapped around the neck there. He can try to get past his half guard position with Joshua Pacio. There's a choke he's got as long as Joshua Pacio holds the head in that position.
Look for finish. Under 3 minutes remaining. First round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Chung right on top of the action. If Pacio can win the title back, the wall of Asia Arena will melt down. To their feet, inside leg kick here from the champion, Saruta. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker, did Joshua Pacio.
Joshua Pacio's going headhunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines, on Abima TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion, doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Saruta. Definitely inside the wall of Asia Arena when they chant Pacio's name. All of Team Legai's former champions are here. Flying Balignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Saruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still Mitch, a filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
Big kibosh from Saruta, and Pacio on the canvas, on his back now.
That's the end of the feeling out process, I assume.
Saruta's got some confidence flowing now. He tries to mount it.
Pacio's got to keep him tight to get his grip back about it. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pacio back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the Russian starting now with Pacio. And he beat the champion to the strikes.
The first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan to perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks away with that belt.
Moving punches from Pacio. 20 seconds remains. Low check there from Saruta. Saruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Taunting with the right hand there. Is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pacio. Pacio jumping roundhouse kick off the lead leg.
Joshua had some early success here as he spins and goes right to the body with a beautifully timed. But then Saruta was able to answer right back with that right hand. Boom! Right on the button.
But it turned out in their thousands for this one. The strawweight world title. Will it be a Filipino victory? Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pacio. Switching stance, Saruta. KG veteran. Has all the tricks in the book. And some that aren't even written in the book. Pacio looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
Action.
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pacio. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pacio.
Spinning back fist from Saruta. Okay. A counter punch. Okay. Pacio accidentally struck the back of the head. Apologies there. Good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500-plus media members, the biggest in history. All over the news and in Team Lakai, athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for one championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love one championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. Falaya saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. Meaning that all of Team Lakai's titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Pacio to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Pacio spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Pacio a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pacio open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective telling blows on Saruta so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Left hand followed by right there by Saruta.
Saruta closes that distance incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pacio seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
Like that strategy employed by Saruta, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pacio is going for that head kick time and time again. And there's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Saruta did last time that confounded Pacio. Oh, overhand right from Saruta, tried for the counter.
Pacio said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time, because you can start to see that Saruta started to time that, started to step to the outside right as Pacio was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pacio's got to be careful with this spinning.
Inside leg kick there from Saruta. Mitch went high on the thigh, but do you think that both men are holding back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down.
Well, in the second round, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. So I don't think Pacio expected Saruta to A, come out in this stance, be this mobile, and I think the Saruta is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pacio, because Pacio said he did not want to wait, he did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds.
Another break off there from Saruta. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pacio. Two rounds down, set for five. Strawweight world title on the line.
Kim Chang had the same concern we did, and he urged the guys to show a little bit more activity in the third round.
Jab from Saruta. Roundhouse kick from Pacio, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab with the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Pacio likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pacio can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yosuke Saruta. Saruta, the current world champion, Pacio, the former world champion. And right there from Pacio.
Saruta is still the owner of the biggest punch to the so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pacio.
Two punch combination from Pacio. Backs off Saruta.
You can start to see the superficial damage on the lower lead leg of Pacio. It's starting to welt up there from that one kick. There's Saruta mixing things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there from Pacio to get back to his feet.
The crowd momentarily thought that Pacio had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Saruta. Mix in the takedowns. Get Pacio thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw, like, so he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand-up.
Pacio fainting. So too Saruta. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Saruta, the cagey one. Pacio tried to counter. Inside leg from Saruta. Key jab, no right hand for company though. Turning back in, looking for the liver of Saruta. It's a Team Lakai specialty. The impact, the liver.
Final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. The impact of Vegas North that closed down the entire body. Say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch here, driving the knuckles up in between the ninth and tenth ribs. But the turning back into the liver will do just as well. Overhand right, the cranium cracker there from Pacio. Just needed a little bit more mustard behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pacio starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is, he's starting to put together those kicks, a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations, he's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning
spinning
back
though. That time Saruta was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. Because the problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it, kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. And also the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these one championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pacio. Saruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
In the third round.
Pacio again bound up and spun on Saruta. Did you expect a little bit more action from Saruta?
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gotten slowed down as the matches went on. But Pacio is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown of Saruta at the beginning.
Overhand right there from Pacio. Inside leg goes Saruta. Final second to the third of five. Two more rounds to go here in Manila.
They have a really good read on what to expect. And so they know each other very, very well. So don't get caught too much in this slow action.
See if we're some more pepper, some more get up and go here. Yosuke Saruta, body punches here from Pacio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corking knees into the thighs.
It's
Pacio turns the champion.
Saruta placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pacio.
Running shot from Pacio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pacio to stab himself in center circle here. Up the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pacio. Some reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pacio, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pacio. Again, Mitch gets in quick. And scores, gets out.
This is the Pacio we expected to see. We want to see those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful stick kick there from Saruta landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
Right counter from Pacio. After a nice left hook from Saruta, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacio. Now all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakai athlete.
Come on! Freaking Irene!
Look at this head kick. I think that reminds me of the Edward Kelly against Bob Mound. Like, knee slash head kick, just starchy. Beautiful head kick, the walk off KO.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout! And new one strawweight world champion, Joshua!
Sold-out ball of Andrew Arena. Michael Chevallo, Mitch Chilson with you. Pacio, a massive 86% finishing rate. Catalan, 50% finishing rate. Riding a six-match winning streak, dating back to September 2016, finishing 3 of 6. Pacio, 8 first-round finishes. 4-1 in his last 5. Pacio, turning back in for the Liberale. It's a Team Lakai specialty. We saw it from Jay Hayustakwio early. Outside leg kick from Catalan, locks up. And Pacio turns him around, throws him in the liver. Gets a takedown, half guard position for the passion.
A beautiful takedown, making it look easy as Pacio lands in half guard. Let's see what Catalan is like on the bottom. We haven't seen him up here a lot. He's usually the one on top dishing out punishment. Now let's see if he can take it as good as he gives it.
Rene Catalan has never competed against a Philippine opponent as a pro. He's a two-time Wushu world champion, Asian Games gold medalist, SEA Games gold medalist, Asian champion. One of the top Wushu exponents of all time. But no chance he is a Wushu on the ground. He only has one submission win in 8 victories. And look at this!
Oh, that was beautiful as he slid into the heel hook. You can see Pacio's trying to attack a toe lock. But it looks like he might want to abandon that idea and go after a... He's actually defending kind of well. with that leg. He's not even enabling the leg to get put in the position. Now, Papillon's rolling into it. He's got to put a foot on the butt and scoop.
Renee Calderon hoping to take the heel home of Joshua Pacio. Pacio has 7 starts in 14 wins and 5 knockouts. And look at Calderon rolling.
He's rolling, trying to get out, but that's just how fast the game of Calderon has developed. See how fast he went up that heel hook? That was beautiful.
And here's Pacio's turn. Remember, Pacio came out in the media and said he could finish Renee Calderon in under 15 minutes.
Got to get out of this knee bar attempt here right now. You can see Calderon is getting going after the leg locks. That's a knee bar right there. That's a bit uncomfortable.
Chant goes up inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's a divided chant. This crowd is split down the center. Half of them for Renee Calderon, half of them for Joshua Pacio. This all-Filipino affair.
Good defense shown by Pacio now. Leg's still in a precarious position. He's got to try to get that leg free, small, heavy, get back up to his feet.
Pacio's favorite submission to the chokes. He's won 3 matches by rear naked choke, 2 by guillotine choke. And he's beaten a Catalan on his record. He's beaten Robin Catalan by second round TKO back in April 2016. He is undefeated 8-0 against Philippine opponents. Interestingly, all of the losses of Joshua Pacio have come against Japanese opposition as he drops an elbow to the jaw of Rene Catalan.
Pacio's in a good position right now to do a little bit of work with the ground and pound. You can see Catalan's got an overhook on the left side, just trying to control that posture. But like this, it also kind of keeps him in that position. He's getting underhook and wants to swim out. So we never know what to expect when Catalan's on the ground. He might try to attack the leg again.
As Pacio tried to draw Catalan to deep water, knowing that Catalan has never been in a 5-round match.
Pacio is 17 years younger than Catalan, so you have to imagine that in the 4th and 5th rounds, if it gets that far, the younger, more vibrant opponent is going to have the advantage. You can never count Catalan out, doing 40-year-olds all over the world proud.
Joshua Pacio has never lost here in Manila. His losses have all been on the road in Macau, Jakarta, and Yangon, Myanmar. Top position for the champion. Crossing elbow, rakes the top lip of Catalan. Catalan trying to control Pacio's posture. Posture's up now, drops a left and a right hand, and immediately Catalan pulls it down. Goes to the body, bang for right hand. Pacio looks to pass, goes there to side control. Dominance here from Pacio.
That was an easy pass, but Renee's giving him a von flu choke. Good job to get back into half guard, but if he keeps that headlock like that, you can see Pacio can drive his shoulder into the neck of Renee Catalan. So Catalan, actually, Joshua should get his hand back into that position. Hit the head and drive his shoulder and try to choke him out.
Look at the jump, turning back kick, smack bang to the liver, and set Catalan back 7 paces.
A Team Lakai specialty, they all use it to absolute perfection. There he is, getting a very heavy takedown on Catalan. Was able to control it, but he gives up the leg, and then they start rolling. Picture me rolling, ladies and gentlemen, as Pacio was able to roll his way free.
Joshua Pacio. 8-3-1 championship Pacio, 4-1 in his last 5. Let's see if he goes the wushu early on, Pacio. We know Catalan will. He fades that left hook for the champion.
Trade left hooks. Catalan was able to touch Pacio. Ooh, he starts spinning again. Look, he's found a home for that heel right on the tummy of Catalan. This is where Pacio is most dangerous. That head kick against Saruta was a thing of beauty. This open range right here, Pacio can just pick and choose his weapons.
We know the stand-up skill of Renee Catalan, a multiple world champion in wushu, but also the wrestling of Catalan. Puts hands on Pacio, picks him up and goes for the big boom shakalaka. He's got huge takedowns, but can he score one on Pacio? Looks for a single leg. Pacio sprawls out nicely, defends the takedown attempt.
Easily sprawls on the takedown there of Catalan. Catalan's legs seem a little bit wobbly, not fully underneath him at this point. A think something might be going wrong with the knee or the ankle. I don't know what's going on. Maybe it was that toe lock that Pacio had, but his legs seem a little bit unsteady in the standing position. Now Pacio's on top, working that half guard position.
Pacio's had a busy year. His third match of 2019. His busiest year since 2016, where he competed 6 times, going 5-1. Inside the half guard at the moment, top position for the champion in the ring.
Pacio might be trying to set up maybe an arm triangle, jumping to the other side. You can see how he's grinding his head upwards into that arm, so he's trying to lift the arm of Rene Catalan up, but he can't do it from this side. He's gonna have to jump to the other side if he wants to sink in this arm triangle, but it's kind of there for him. Now he's going into mount, the head is still there. If he can pass the other leg over, he might have an arm triangle.
And there's a time not long ago.
Yep, there it is. Let's see if he steps over. Now he's in full mount. Not quite set up correctly, but if he swings over to the other side, he can do it in full mount. Now he's got it locked in.
Now
that's
a
bad spot.
Is this the time for Pacio to take the lead? Catalan's in trouble. Catalan's in big trouble.
Pacio's got a good squeeze. He's got a good squeeze here.
The grimace on the face is about to tap out.
Got a wrap.
Is he about to tap out? He is. It's over. It's good night, Irene. Joshua Pacio retains the title. He's our heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera. And have a look at this again.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Pacio's got a tight squeeze. And once he had it locked in, it was academic.
For your winner, by way of arm triangle choke, and still one Strawweight World Champion, Joshua Pacio.
He said, well, you want to do it inside of two? I'll do it inside of one. And they go to ground inside the opening 17 seconds.
I asked Silva if he was going to pull guard. He said, I'm thinking about it. And he just did just that. Got the overhook, slid right into guard. Now he gets to work his magic off his back. Good job by Pacio to escape that. I let him back up.
Indeed. Pacio allows the former champion back to his feet. Bruce Simpson, Wushu striking now from Pacio. Good counter right hand there from Alex Silva. Pacio with a polo punch.
Pacio is standing his ground. He's not too concerned with the way that Alex Silva's closing that distance into boxing range. Alex Silva's getting very close. He can touch you with the hands. He might be able to drop down and snatch up a single leg.
We know the improved striking on Silva, particularly with his leg kicks. We saw that against Naito, when he beat Naito with beautiful leg kicks. Step up knee there from Pacio. Open in orthodox stance. Thrusting jab from Pacio. Silva looks for a low single leg. Wild hands there from Little Rock Alex Silva. Pacio looks calm and collected. The young 24-year-old champion. The 37-year-old former champion. Eats an uppercut off the right hand.
Look at the timing of Pacio. These are clean, crisp strikes that he's landing. Everything from the uppercut to the head kick that I'm sure is coming real soon. He is starting to figure out the distance and the speed of Alex Silva.
Silva momentarily switched to southpaw, now back to orthodox. Charges in, clinches up with Pacio. They do a tango. Backed up against the wall here, dropped down for a single leg to Silva.
This is what Silva has to do. He has to chain wrestle. He has to tack the single leg. If he doesn't get it, he's got to float into something else. But he is able to get this. He's not maybe the way that he wants to do it, but he is able to get this contest to the ground.
Is this advantageous for Silva or for Pacio?
Anything on the ground is advantageous for Alex Silva. He is a BJJ world champion who has very incredibly fast submission skills. You make one mistake, you leave one limb exposed, and he will try to take it back home to Singapore.
Mitch, is there a situation where you could see Pacio possibly submitting Silva?
I mean, anything is possible in this game, especially if Pacio starts launching into some of these big head kicks. If he can stumble Alex Silva and then jump on top of him, catch him, and as he's discombobulated for a finish, I can see that happening. But in a straight grappling situation, probably not gonna happen.
Nice jump turning back kick game for the liver from Joshua Pacio, the young champion of the Philippines in the red, the challenger of Brazil in the white. 150 remaining, first round set for five. World Strawweight Championship on the line. Southpaw back to orthodox for Alex Silva. On the balls of his feet, Silva. High kick nicely done, roundhouse off the lead leg, no switch up from Pacio.
How composed Joshua Pacio is. Completely relaxed and calm, just waiting for his moment, picking his shots.
Not rushing, not overextending. He knows the wily veteran that is Alex Silva, and Silva knows all the tricks in the book. Silva even wrote some of the tricks in the book.
Silva competed at one championship, two. 2012, that's how long he's been in this game, man. He's got so much experience. This is his moment. He might not get another shot at the top of the mountain.
Southpaw stance again from Silva, now back to orthodox. Skip up outside, leg kick from the Brazilian. Punch Pacio to go to ground. Pacio says no. Amethyst to the foot of Silva. Quite ready to let the former champion up. Swings the legs a little. Olivia Goss may allow him to stand up in a moment. And up they get. A very big difference in style. The striker, Pacio, the grappler, Silva. Now Silva top position. Could be stuck in the guillotine here. This may be Pacio's chance to sub Alex Silva. For Silva's sake. He's seen it all before. Top position now for the little one.
Silva needs to keep that pressure. He can't allow Joshua Pacio to have any little bit of space. He's just able to end this match on top. Nice little attempt at a leg block there. He dives just as the last 10 seconds. I like the strategy coming from Alex Silva. Joshua Pacio's confidence got to be at an all-time high. Look at this beautiful timing. This is what Alex Silva needs to be concerned with. It's these entries into the takedowns. Pacio is starting to figure out this timing. If he takes another step back, starts launching into uppercuts, and he starts to work the timing of that knee. Here's a guillotine attempt by Alex Silva.
Round two. Choke. And they touch gloves for round two. An impressive opening stanza from the champion. Overhand right from Silva. High kick from Pacio. Silva locks onto a single leg. Pacio not going to ground. And now puts Silva on his back.
Look at the way Silva's trying, chasing those legs, hunting after a leg lock. Good job by Pacio to settle down, control the scramble. Now he's in guard. Let's see if Alex Silva starts to push down those legs. Alex Silva has an old school style of BJJ. He likes to pass the guard, get into side control, look for mounts, and then look for one of those arm bars.
Alex Silva, a 100% submission finishing rate. Every time he has finished an opponent, he's done so via submission. Now, don't forget, Silva said he would finish Pacio inside of 2 rounds. He's got 3:55 remaining to make it come true. He's stuck in an attempted guillotine choke, but he's out of it. Inside the closed out of Pacio. It was a very bold statement. Unlike anything we've ever heard from Silva. Usually doesn't make predictions, Alex Silva. Usually says what will be. Certainly made a statement. Good finish, Pacio, inside of 10 minutes.
Good job by Pacio, just to kind of control the overhooks, control the head posture of Silva, not letting Silva posture up and start dropping ground and pound, not allowing Silva to work his way past the full guard here of Joshua Pacio. Pacio still looks relaxed and comfortable. Silva's got to push down on that leg, try to work past it.
3 minutes, 5 remains. Silva still inside the guard of the Filipino. It's been a mixed bag for Team Lakai on our main card tonight. The win for Danny Kinga, the loss for Edward Filiang. And now the only remaining world champion from Team Lakai, Joshua Pacio, trying to keep the gold in Baguio. Closes the guard again.
You can see the way Silva's trying to shove his head underneath the armpit. He's possibly looking for an arm triangle choke. He's got to get past the legs of
Joshua Pacio. Nice little transition here. You can see how he sits up, controls the leg there. It's kind of a modified rubber guard, trying to control the posture of Joshua Pacio.
Feet on hips here from Silva. Now Pacio back to his feet. Silva circles off clockwise into the power side of Pacio. Got to watch the head kick. The one that spectacularly knocked out Saruta in what was declared the knockout of the year. It was in April of last year, the head kick that came in the fourth round against Saruta. And there it is, an attempt from Pacio. Top position here for Alex Silver Dragon.
Yeah, Silver's doing a good job of getting this match to where he wants, but he's not really doing anything with it once this gets to the ground. And Joshua Pacio's got good defense. They knew they were going to be in these kind of positions, so they drilled it over and over, making sure Pacio could maintain his guard and stay out of danger. And even when Silva does able, you know, to work his way past the guard, choose to let it go. So he's trying to step over the legs into half guard. So they're trying to push that knee down a little bit. But Pacio's doing a good job of staying out of danger. Nice job by Silva to float over. Now he's looking for a possible head and arm choke if he can get to the other side. Actually finish it from this position right here. You can still apply that pressure with your shoulder and drive in. You don't have to be fully committed to the other side. You can choke from this position. It's applied even more in full mount. Here comes the squeeze.
Alex Silva now applies the pressure to Joshua Pacio. Can he take the championship belt back to Brazil? Alex Silva. Pacio defending.
Good work by Joshua Pacio.
30 seconds remaining for Silva to find a finish inside of two rounds as he predicted. And Pacio survived. Silva keeps the Filipino on his back. Silva, who defended the title last time in all for a pair of four against Rene Catalan, beat him in the second round by arm triangle cut. Thanks again. It looked like Pacio will get out of the second round. Now go into the third. Not where Silva thought he would be.
Look at this arm triangle. This was deep. First he had it in full mount. Joshua Pacio is tough as nails. This is deep right here. This is a black belt level squeeze, ladies and gentlemen.
Round three. Two. Third round of five for the Strawweight World Championship. In the red, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. In the white, the former champion. Tonight, the challenger, the rock Alex Silva. Get folks to follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Let us know your thoughts so far. Outside of the kick from Pacio. Pacio, the master of inventive and explosive highlight reel finishes. Alex Silva in the third round thought he beat Pacio inside of two.
I can see Pacio fake that punch and then land a kick. You can see the way Silva's starting to cover up. He's fully shielding himself and he's kind of blinded from the oncoming attacks. Pacio could land heavy body and leg kicks when he does that.
It has been a long time since we've seen Team Lakai without championship gold. If Pacio loses tonight, that will be the case.
Nice little knee as Alex Silva tried to close that distance. Do not want to allow Joshua Pacio to get comfortable in this range. Look at the jab.
Uppercut there from Pacio. These two men represent the two mega gyms in Asia. The Evolve MMA, Alex Silva, Team Lakai, Joshua Pacio. Both have produced a multitude of world champions across all divisions.
Man, that's an unconventional way to get it to the ground. That's the third time that he's kind of pulled guard to get Joshua Pacio out down, but it works. Now he's got that butterfly hook on that side, so he's going to try to elevate it. Might be looking for the legs again. Good job by Pacio to work his way back up again.
Let's see if Pacio can affect some of the wuxi striking now. The escapes from Pacio tonight, the improving escapes of all the Team Lakai combatants.
Man, you would think Harry Houdini is a coach over there at Team Lakai, because these guys vanish into thin air when you try to grab hold of them.
Cycling. He's left here into the power cycle. Watch the round kick of Joshua Pacio. Come off the right leg. Downstairs with a jab from Pacio. Silva edging forward, wants to put hands on him, get a takedown, get Pacio possibly on his back.
I'd like to see more kicks coming from Silva. He has no fear of being taken down, so he might as well let go. Some fancy footwork.
Nice deep hooks again there from Pacio. We might see some leg kicks from Silva. We know he does have the knees out of the way. Highly improved strikes. Two punch combination from the Brazilian. Ball there from Pacio. Switches from a single to a double. Now up around the waist goes Alex Silva. 1 minute victory remains. Third round of five, Dragon.
Good job by Silva to work his way back up. You can see he went for the single, chain wrestled his way back into a body lock. He might look to pull guard again here. Pacio's takedown defense has been good, except for this pulling guard. That's the only thing that's
at only 24 years old, so many records already set by Pacio. Most title bouts in one strawweight history. Most submissions in one strawweight history. Second most wins in one strawweight history. And second most finishes in one strawweight history. 15-3 record, a massive 86% finishing rate, 8 subs, 5 knockouts. Beat Rene Catalan by arm triangle last time. To defend the title. First, that magnificent head kick knockout in the fourth round against Saruta. We know that Pacio can finish opponents in the deep water in the latter rounds. Close guard from the champion at the moment.
You gotta think the youth advantage that he's got, the 13 years younger that Pacio is, that's going to play in his favor as the match goes on. But now they're starting to get slippery too, so it's going to be even harder for Silva to hold on to Pacio. So that's going to play into the favor of the explosive Team Lakai athlete, Joshua Pacio.
25 seconds remaining in what has been a thrilling contest so far. Nice and cool inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We hit about 32 degrees Celsius in Manila today. It's currently 25 degrees outside.
Yes, again.
Which sends some sweat starting to form on all these athletes. Jump to him, back kick aims towards the liver of Alex Silva. And there's trying to get the shin around the back of the neck.
Interesting third round, but a lot of work was done from Joshua Pacio standing. His knees are timed beautifully. The ways that he's able to figure out the distance, as you can see, Silva tries to get in tight, closing. But then Silva says, hey, I got knees of my own.
Round four.
Top. Broadcast to over 140 countries. Hope you're enjoying all the action. Don't forget, follow us on social media at One Championship on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. High kick there from Silva. Southpaw starts from the Brazilian. Round kick from Joshua Pacio. Switching starts is Silva. Drop down, looking for a takedown, but Pacio in top position.
Beautiful little underhook push down right there from Joshua Pacio to maintain that top position. You know, in these fourth and fifth rounds, you have got to give a slight advantage to the conditioning of Joshua Pacio. These guys regularly run up mountains for their morning runs. Like, just the endurance that these guys are known for. They can push hard all five rounds.
They're always training at altitude, right? Mitch Baggio is up there in the hills.
Yes, it is.
What altitude is Baggio City at?
It's 11,000 feet. Could be wrong. Put me up on Twitter.
And for a downward elbow, Pacio from inside the guard of Alex Silva. A little bit of damage under the right eye around the orbital of Silva. That was mostly incurred in the first round from the striking of Pacio. One foot on hips here from Alex Silva. Controlling the posture of the Filipino, the world champion in the red trunks. Which is consulting Google at the moment to find out the elevation of Baguio City, just to clarify. Pacio Can he get the arms free here and drop some leather, some anvils on the face of Alex Silva? Silva trying to lift him. To no avail, though, for the former world champion. Butterfly guard now for Alex Silva. A lot of options available. Back to a foot on hips here for Silva.
You can see that Alex Silva's having a hard time getting a hold on Joshua Pacio because of the slipperiness, that this sweat after four rounds is starting to build up. But Alex Silva's constantly looking for different attacks. He's got so much mat time in his life. He's so dangerous, especially off his back. But that sweat, you can see Joshua Pacio was able to pull out because the legs are slippery now.
Crowd loving the chance that Pacio may be able to strike now. Genuflect position back onto his feet for Pacio. And the boss, Olivia Cross, says to Alex Silva, stand up. By the way, Mitch Bagyar sitting 5,000 feet above sea level. Jab two, another jab there from Pacio. Turns the knuckles in on the lead hook as Pacio. And Silva comes forward. Knee to a right hand. High kick from Silva. They came close for the Brazilian. Body shot from Pacio. Silva edges forward, goes the outside thigh kick. Right bent trade jab. Left hand from Silva, didn't have the mustard behind it.
I gotta say that Joshua Pacio is putting a lot of the critics of Team Lakai to rest. There has been so much talk about the lack of ground game coming from Team Lakai, but he is showing a definitely elevated level of grappling. He's been able to stop all of Alex Silva's attacks on the ground. Look at it, piecing him up with that jab. Beautifully done on that straight right hand.
Oh, high kick was spinning back to the left hand. What a combination from Pacio. A beautiful combination. Now a double leg, and now a single leg from Silva. And Pacio defending. Silva wants the Filipino, the world champion, on his back.
Look at Alex Silva, he's trying to float over, but a good job by Pacio to maintain that guard. But look at that reversal. Now Joshua Pacio's on top. Alex Silva does a nice little hip escape to retain half guard.
This is a thrilling contest. This highly educated Philippines crowd enjoying the ground battle between Pacio and Silva.
You can see how Silva tries to go underneath that leg, trying to attempt deep half, looking for a submission. But Joshua Pacio, very well educated on the ground game, able to keep those heavy hips and prevent Silva from going anywhere.
Feet on hips from Silva. Trying to sub out Joshua Pacio. 20 seconds remains, fourth round of five.
Little elevator sweep there, beautifully done. Once he got that butterfly hook in, he was able to elevate Pacio over and reverse the position. Now he's gonna push that leg down, end up in mount.
Once again, doesn't get the full mount from Pacio, the champion, back to his feet. Final seconds, we are going into the deepest of deep water. We're going in for the fifth and final round.
Look at him, timing beautifully done, leans back, little hand exchange there as Pacio floats backwards. Beautiful little knee to a right hand, but then Silva throwing a head kick of his own. Pacio backs up and beautiful little shoulder roll.
Ready? One of two Filipino world champions on the one championship roster. The other being in attendance, the heavyweight world champion, Brandon Vera. And a roundhouse kick to the ribcage there from Pacio. Jumping knee! Jumping knee! And a takedown from Silva!
His timing on that knee is something spectacular. That was a jumping knee that caught Silva flush, walked right through it, still able to get the takedown, put it down on the ground where he wants the match most. Now he's trying to work his way past the half guard. Good job by Pacio to retain full guard.
Explosive start from Joshua Pacio. Now top position for Alex Silva. Silva is so cunning, so wily, a victory. As Mitch said earlier, he's been here since one championship, number two. 37-year-old former champion, 24-year-old current champion. And what a thrilling show they've put on so far.
closed guard here from Joshua Pacio.
You gotta wonder at this point, how did the judges see it? It's been so close. There's been a lot of top control coming from Alex Silva, but we're not seeing ground control. He's not really advancing his position in a lot of these ground grappling exchanges. He's not passing the guard. He's not working into mount. He's been held in one position. That's inside the guard of Pacio. But has Pacio been doing enough work on the feet to push that far ahead? It's been an interesting tactical strategy by both these athletes so far to see how things have played out in the first four rounds. And now we're approaching the fifth round. It could come down to this.
You know what? He's won championship debut back in 2012 at one championship number two. Alex Silva was beaten by a member of Team Lokai in Jay Hayastakwia.
See that Alex Silva has been attempting these, trying to pull guard, trying to drop down to his back. You know, you gotta wonder, are the escapes of Joshua Pacio, the way that he is defending, gonna weigh that heavily in the judges' eyes? In my mind, probably not, because they like to see them as faceless athletes, as, you know, not paying attention to anything of their skill set and just weighing what happens right in front of them.
2 minutes 25 remains, fifth and final round. Fake there from Silva. Thought about a sidekick, Wushu style, did Pacio. Silva southpaw stance, edging forward the Brazilian now, switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Pacio thought about sliding with a jolt jab. Leads him with a hook instead. It is still anyone's for the taking. 120 seconds remaining. Leg kick there from Silva. Jump pointed back kick! Hoping to find the liver of Alex Silva. The one that Kevin Ballion famously caught Andrew Leone with. That sent Leone across the ring some 15 paces. Single leg lock on here from Silva, hunting for a takedown. Hopscotch time for Joshua Pacio. Still can't get him down, now he does. Top position, half guard for Alex Silva.
Nice single leg takedown for Silva. He's got 90 seconds to do work. He might be slightly behind in the judges' scorecards if you take in striking superiority into factor. And that's kind of the only thing that we're really seeing from Pacio. We're seeing a lot of top control. He has been able to land a couple of takedowns, but I don't know if pulling guard really counts as a takedown as well, because you're not controlling the opponent's hips. That single leg takedown was a takedown because he pulled him down, secured the hips, and was able to stay on top. But he's not showing ground control. He's not passing the guard of Pacio, as Pacio gives a thumbs up to his fellow Colombians.
Thumbs up to the crowd for the Gotham Young World Champion, Joshua Pacio. What improvements Pacio has made over the last 18 months. Almost unrecognizable, especially with his ground game. Nice elbow there, and Pacio forced to quickly count his teeth. Looking for the ground and pound Silva. Postures up now, the Brazilian gets elevated by Pacio momentarily. 30 seconds to go, half guard position. They're screaming for Pacio. What has Silva got left with 20 seconds remaining? Can he get the right leg out? Can he pass guard, go to side control? No, he stays inside a half guard. Has he got a final squeeze? What's he got here, Alex Silva? Once again, we're gonna go down with Joshua's in the middle. Comes right with the left hand to Silva. Now switches to the right hand of the body. And up to the hand, Alex Silva.
Going to the judges' scorecards. Look at Joshua Pacio slowly backing up. Joe's for the jumpy knee. Gives up the leg in the process, and that puts him in a position where he's able to get taken down. Another single leg takedown, but in that instance, he was able to control the hips and get on top. But Pacio plays to the crowd, gives us a thumbs up.
Still!